Okay, we are back in Ace Academy. And this should be the final time, folks, because it's time to tackle Mayu's route. So we'll go ahead and hit start. We have to put in the usual information, which is probably second nature at this point.
Attention passengers.
So let's speed through this as fast as we can, same as every other time before. And we're gonna try to get to the Mayu choices. Now I know some people had some reservations about this route. Mainly because they were afraid that means you're going to break up Sho and Mayu, since they sort of become an item over the other routes. We'll take the bus and meet Yuna just so we can get this over with. Ask her where her class is. She can get us the permit a lot faster if I remember.
You're done. Is it okay? Not good. Maybe you're next!
So we'll memorize this. Unfortunately, I never bothered trying to figure out if that information actually would come into play or stuff. So we'll just hit him up right here so we can get it over with. By the way, in case you were wondering about Sho's route, I don't think I'm gonna do his. But otherwise, there are some other projects that have started to arise that I want to tackle. This is pretty much the... Actually, yeah, this will be the final major project of 2016. So we'll just do this real quick. I wonder if it's actually faster if you try to do it properly. But as long as you always have something going on, I think you're gonna have free food. We get to meet Akira for the first time this playthrough. And I guess Kaido belches so loud you can hear him over the motorcycle.
Yeah!
It's big.
So, that's that. Damn, is there one I haven't chose? I think I did that one. No, okay, I haven't done this one. Their uniforms leave nothing to the imagination. I eagerly watch the girls as they approach. Have I just died and gone to heaven?
Hello?
Hey!
Kaori's angry eyes snap me out of my reverie. Her hands are on her hips.
What do you think you're doing?
I was just admiring your incredibly effective and intelligent distraction tactic. Sho and the girls stare blankly at me.
What?
With you wearing these uniforms, the other team will be so distracted that they'll forget about the battle and give us the advantage. Mayu brings up her arms to hide her chest, mortified. Kaori glares at me and crosses her arms.
How would the opposing team see us when we're inside a giant robot? Exactly. These suits are for functional purposes. Nothing more. Don't be a pervert!
After scolding me, Kaori and Mayu circled the table. Sho shakes his head.
That was an amateur mistake, Brosif.
You've got to sneak a peek, my man. Can't be so obvious about it.
He claps me on the back after imparting his words of wisdom, then joins the girls at the table. Skip button's enabled, so we're just gonna go ahead and hit that. YOLO! Oh, right. You're welcome. So we're gonna raise Kaori's blood pressure as much as possible. You didn't ask. You didn't ask. Kaori puts her hands on her
because
hips.
Because it's totally normal to ask everyone if they have a unique core or not.
Hey, I'm not a mind reader.
Well, I'm asking now. What did you do with your core?
I shrug again. Couldn't tell you.
Huh?
Involves a whole lot of duct tape. In fact, that mech may be like 90% duct tape. Please, it's me. And my duct tape mech. Maybe hard to believe, but that mech started out as a different color before it became solid gray. I wonder what Mayu is up to. I dial her number, and she answers almost immediately.
Hello?
Hi, it's Hiro.
Oh, hi.
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 We pause. I didn't think this through. So, how are you?
Good, thank you. And you?
Good, good. I can practically hear her confusion.
Are you looking for Sho?
Well, I'm interrupted by a clamoring in the background. Can make out a muffled Sho.
Me? Is it for me?
Her voice becomes clear.
Sup, Brosim?
Oh, hey, Sho. Are you and Mayu hanging out?
Yeah, we're just at the cafe getting our nom on. Come join us.
Yeah, why not? You don't mind?
No way. The more the merrier.
Cool. I'll be right over.
See you soon.
Let me hang up and I head to my bike. So it's time to become the third wheel. Sho waves me over to the back of the cafe where he and Mayu are sitting. Mayu smiles when she notices me.
Hi!
Hey, Mayu, Sho.
Good to see you, man! Have a seat!
Thanks. I sit down beside Mayu. Sho slides me a menu, I quickly scan it, and when the waitress comes over, I ask for a green tea latte. The waitress leaves as soon as I order. What about you guys?
Oh, it's okay. We already ordered.
I see how you guys are. Oh.
So what rank do you think we earned?
I don't know if that's actually a thing all over the world, but it's supposed to be courtesy not to order until the whole party has arrived. Huh?
From the qualifiers.
Somewhere on the lower end of the spectrum.
Oh, I thought we did well.
Yeah, but there were a lot of factors against us, and I don't think we were at our peak.
Well, I think we're going to get a good ranking. What do you think, Mayu?
We'll probably be somewhere in the 20s range.
That's pretty good.
The waitress sets down my latte. I breathe in the fragrant tea and take a sip. Tastes even better than it smells. The perfect mixture of tea and milk.
How is it?
Amazing. Sho grins.
Now you know our worst kept secret. This is the best cafe on campus.
Worst kept secret?
Because everyone else knows this place is good, too.
Yeah.
Oh. They both wait patiently while I sip my drink. Didn't you guys order two? Well, you nuts. So, where are your drinks?
We finished them.
You mean you guys had ordered and finished your drinks before I even arrived?
Yeah.
Oh. Another silence falls. Suddenly, my tea seems very interesting. After a few minutes, Mayu stands.
I'm sorry. But I just remembered I need to go. I promised my father I'd meet him later today.
Sho seems surprised.
Really? I thought earlier you said you were free all day.
I'm sorry. I had forgotten about this. I'll catch up with you later.
Yep, third wheel. We exchange goodbyes and she leaves. I continue sipping my drink while Sho watches her walk away, his face a mirror of curiosity and skepticism. Once she's completely out of earshot, I turn back towards Sho. Mayu left kind of in a hurry.
Yeah.
Is that normal?
No.
I wonder if she's disappointed I dropped in and interrupted them. Do you think she left because of me? Glances at me in surprise.
Why'd you think that?
Well, I don't know. She left pretty soon after I arrived. Is there anything going on between you two?
Nothing. We're just friends.
Does she know that?
Huh?
I kind of get the feeling that she might be into you. Show pauses, then bursts out laughing.
That's silly. Mayu and I have known each other for years. I'm pretty sure she sees me as her older brother.
So, you wouldn't mind if I maybe ask her out sometime? Sho flashes me a wide grin.
For real? You two would be great together. Mayu's an awesome girl.
It's gonna make this whole beach thing a little more interesting. Yeah, I can tell. We'll be polite. You guys may want a couple extra minutes on your content. So, how's your year doing after the qualifiers? Obviously, mine has seen better days, such as when I first got it before all that duct tape became necessary.
She's hanging in there.
Okay, I've got to ask. Why do you call your gear a she?
Well, you know how some people call their cars and boats a she? Well, Emerald is my boat.
Okay, but then how come she hasn't got a female frame?
Because that's me.
What?
You know, the gear embodies the pilot.
Yeah, I know that, but if the essence of your gear is a female and the gear embodies the pilot, then you...
I can see where you're going with this, and I'm gonna stop you right there because that's not it. As a vessel, I refer to her as a female, but the aesthetics and frame and whatnot are a reflection of me.
Oh, right. I nod, but I'm still not sure if I completely understand. As the conversation lulls to a close, I take another sip from what I'm surprised to find is an empty cup.
You done with that?
Apparently, yeah.
Want another one?
No, I'm good, thanks. Let's hit the arcade. Are you doing anything after this?
Not that I know of.
I'm thinking of heading to the arcade to practice. We can play a few rounds.
Sounds good to me.
I only know of one by my house. Is there a closer one?
Yeah, there's a good one nearby. I'll take you there.
Cool. We both pay for our orders, then Shil leads me to the arcade. We play simulated gear matches until it gets late. Then we say our goodbyes and head home. I hung out with friends.
Oh yeah? You have friends?
Ouch. Very funny. Nikki grins.
Who?
Just showing Mayu for my team. Nikki's friends lean into her and whisper.
What team is he talking about? His pilot team. Oh.
They both glance appreciatively at me again. How else would you describe me? You have to be hero. So here we go with our first... this is her studying the library, I guess? They go to the library to study. I sit down at a secluded desk between the stacks of books. After a couple minutes, I think I hear a muffled thumping as if someone trying to quiet their jumping. Following the noise to a nearby stack, I see Mayu balancing on her toes, trying to reach a book on the top shelf. Her fingers barely graze the ledge of the shelf. She tries a dainty hop, but still fails to reach the book. As she sighs, she bows and raises herself to try again. Stifling a laugh, I walk over and easily pull out the book that she needs. Mayu blinks at me as I hand it to her.
Oh, thank you!
She hugs the book to her chest and stares shyly at the ground. No problem. Seemed like you could use some help there. Her cheeks redden as she nods. I take another look at the book she's holding. Hey, isn't that a Piloting 101 textbook?
Yeah.
I thought so. I guess you're working on the assignment now.
Yeah.
She gives me a strange look. I only know this because I have to retake Piloting 101. I'm not stalking you or anything.
Oh, okay. That's good to know.
There is a long pause. Mayu refuses to make eye contact with me, and I'm worried I might have scared her when she suddenly speaks.
Why do you have to take Piloting 101 again?
As soon as the words leave her mouth, her eyes grow wide and her blush deepens.
I'm sorry! I didn't mean to be rude!
I can't help but grin at her reaction. Don't worry, it's a normal question. Basically, my credit from CIN wide didn't transfer. Apparently some of the material is different here from the introductory course, but so far everything we've covered has been the same.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. That said, since I've taken this class before, if you ever need help, feel free to ask me. She smiles.
That would be great.
We stand in silence again. She seems like she wants to ask me something, but is too shy to say it. Let's just be forthright. Would you like any help now?
Sure. But only if it's not too much trouble.
Of course not. I always have time for my friends. Her eyes meet mine when I say friend before she quickly looks away again. Another blush stains her cheeks. Despite that, she smiles and nods. We sit down at the desk together and I go over my notes with her. As we settle at the desk, I pull out my tablet and Mayu pulls out a spiral notebook. She opens her textbook and flips it to the correct page, then opens her notebook to a fresh page, her pencil at the ready, as she begins to read the text. I watch her curiously as she meticulously writes her notes in fine print. After a couple minutes, she looks up and her eyes meet for a second before she looks away. A blush stains her cheeks. Are you writing your notes? Mayu seems self-conscious. Did we flash back to the year 2000? This may seem a little mean, but I think I did the actual positive one last time. I didn't realize anyone still did that. It's kind of an antiquated method. Mayu frowns and fidgets uncomfortably.
I know. It's a little weird.
Using a tablet is more efficient. You can type a lot faster than you can when you write, which is especially helpful during lectures when the professor talks kind of fast.
That's true, but I'm more comfortable writing things down. I feel like I understand the material better when I have to pay attention to what I'm noting.
Really? She nods. How did you get into that habit?
I wasn't allowed to have electronics when I was growing up.
I can't remember the last time I was without my tablet. How did you survive? Mayu giggles.
Well, it wasn't so bad. I think that's where I got my love of books. I wasn't allowed to play games very often, but Father always encouraged reading. He said he didn't want me to get distracted from my studies, so that's why I wasn't allowed to have a tablet.
It sounds like your father takes your education very seriously.
He does. I was in high school when I got my first tablet, but by then I was so used to using a pen and paper that typing out my notes felt unnatural.
Well, the one upside to writing all the time is that your handwriting is really neat. I wouldn't be able to read my notes if I wrote everything down. Mayu giggles.
I'm sure that's not true.
I read somewhere once that a person's handwriting can say a lot about them.
Oh, really?
Well, your characters are all very neat and small. Your strokes are slightly rounded, not angular or spiky, which means you're an introvert.
What does that mean?
Hold on. I'm kind of tempted to do this one. You know what? Let's do it. It means you like to believe a lot of things. She furrows her brow in confusion, and I can't help but laugh. I have no idea what it means. I don't really believe handwriting is an indicator of personality.
I suppose you're right.
Mayu smiles faintly, but seems a little disappointed. Anyway, we should focus on the assignment.
Right.
She turns back to her text, and I return to mine. As I'm reading, I can see Mayu glancing at me out of the corner of her eye. I look up.
Do you think you could explain this passage to me?
It's blank. I grin. Of course. I continue to help her until her assignment is complete. I'm fine. How are you?
Quite well. Do you need... I am. Oh.
So, she's gonna turn us down, but I'll join you. So we're gonna hit up Yuna because I know we've done her event.
I agree.
Whiff. Return. Okay, I can take a hint. Didn't know you managed restaurants. I'm with Kaori on this one. Drop it for now. must be a fetish model. Oh.
Huh?
Let me guess. You have a maid outfit and a naughty nurse costume hidden in your closet, too. This is all starting to make sense. First it was your pilot outfit, now gym uniform. I just never would have thought someone like Kaori would be in that line of work. Kaori's mouth hangs open as her face reddens.
What are you saying? You are a special kind of idiot to say something so perverted!
You know, it is starting to make a lot more sense now.
With eyes closed, Sho rubs his chin as if he's contemplating some great revelation. Wham! Ouch!
This is a new low! Even for you!
Even with her hostile glare, Kaori's blushy, pouty face is strangely cute. Pat the little cutie on the head. Duh, sorry, Kaori. I go to pat Kaori on the head. Eck. When a surging pain in my wrist stops me, Kaori grabs my arm before it reaches her and puts me in a painful lock.
I'll show you sorry!
She nudges her hand forward, causing another rush of pain to flow through me. Oh, okay, sorry for real.
Yes, me too. Just please spare the unenlightened fool.
I rub my aching wrist as soon as she releases my arm. Remind me to never to mess with you again.
At least you're learning.
She's a feisty one, I'll give her that. I actually don't remember her second event. It's such a nice day that I decide to go do some studying outside. I make myself comfortable on a bench in the courtyard when I see Mayu walk past. She is carrying a violin case with her. Hey, Mayu. I stand and wave, she turns at the sound of her name and comes over when she sees me.
Hi! I didn't see you there.
No worries. Where are you headed?
I'm going to the music room.
She shuffles the case from one hand to the other. That's cool. You play the violin? Why, you nuts? Yeah, I took lessons as a kid, played all throughout high school.
That's great! I started when I was a kid, too. My father always believed that music is an integral part of a person's education.
He sounds like a smart man.
He is.
I'd love to hear you play sometime. Mayu's eyes grow wide and her hands tremble.
Oh, I don't know. I think I'd be too embarrassed.
How come?
It's so embarrassing to play in front of an audience. I practice alone.
So you've never performed at a recital or anything? She shakes her head.
No, I've always had private lessons, so I've never had to play in front of a crowd before.
I'll teach you a trick. Just imagine everyone in their underwear. I mean, in that case, you don't have to be embarrassed. They should be embarrassed. Mayu's face turns beet red and she stutters her response.
I couldn't possibly!
Okay, how about we make a deal? I'll do something embarrassing, then you'll play for me.
No, you don't have to do that!
But if I do, you'll play for me, right? She bites her lip, or he clouds her eyes. Don't be afraid, watch this. Famous last words. In one long leap, I jump onto the bench, but I miscalculate my distance and my foot hits the edge of the seat. I windmill my arms, trying to catch my balance. I end up toppling over the back of the bench, falling face first into the grass. All the surrounding students pause to stare at me. The laughter that follows seems to stretch forever before it gradually dies down. Once everyone loses interest, I untangle my limbs and push myself to standing. My cheeks are burning as I check myself for bruises. That definitely did not go as planned.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Mayu's face and neck are bright red. As I straighten up, she hides her face in her hands.
I can't believe you did that!
Hey, why are you embarrassed? I'm the one who did that, and I'm okay.
I don't know.
She lowers her hands and glances at me. I grin at her. See? I'm still alive. Mayu hesitates, then she laughs. I've never noticed how cute her laugh is. She notices me staring and hides her laughter with her hand.
What?
Nothing. It's your turn now. Mayu shakes her head.
I can't! It's too embarrassing! But I promise, I'll play for you another time. But only when it's just you.
I nod. I'll hold you to it. She smiles.
I'd better get to practice now.
Sure. I'm going to go somewhere where no one just watched me do that. Mayu giggles again, then waves goodbye. Primarily the nurse's office, I imagine. When she's gone, I find a secluded area on campus to finish studying. Hang out in the pilot's lounge. Nothing alcoholic. I don't really remember what they're talking about. Okay. Sho, let's go on a date.
Isn't it a little too soon to switch teams?
I thought about it, and I realized you're the only person I want to be with.
Wait, are you being serious right now?
More serious than I've ever been. The next few seconds of silence are painfully awkward. Of course I'm kidding. Want to hit up the arcade?
Oh, of course. I knew it was a joke. I was just playing along.
Of course. Although he tries to play it cool, I can tell he's flustered.
I'm down for the arcade. I'll meet you there.
Okay, there's supposed to be... I don't remember when you can... or how it is you avoid this event, but that's why I only hit a couple of different options here. I'm going to get you back one day, Sho. Turn it around on her. We'll go for a sandwich. Mayu. And we finally hit a unique event that has not been featured in any of the other playthroughs. I wonder if Mayu is serious about playing the violin for me. I'm actually really curious how well she plays. I dial Mayu's number. She answers the phone.
Hello?
Hey Mayu, about that violin session. Well, I'm ready to listen if you're ready to play.
Sorry, but my father is coming to visit again. And I have errands I need to run before he gets here.
So now you have to ask, by father does she actually mean father or sugar daddy? Wasn't her father just here? Oh, he comes to visit often, doesn't he? There's a slight pause, and I'm positive she's nodding.
He's an alumni of Ace, and has regular business with the dean. So he's here very often.
Your father knows the dean?
Yeah. They were classmates here at Ace. But that's not why he's here so often. Ace has the strongest pilot program in Japan. So naturally, most of the graduates here are accepted into my father's military program.
He and the dean have been working together to build a bridging program between Ace and the military college.
Okay, they lost a filter there. And your father teaches at the military college?
Yep.
That's pretty impressive. I knew Mayu's father was pretty distinguished based on what I'd heard about him, but I had no idea he was this distinguished. No wonder Mayu always seemed worried or stressed when he comes to visit. I mean, it would be if Hideo Akemi came to visit. I don't actually know who this is. Wait a minute. Mayu. Your last name is Akemi.
Yes?
The same Akemi as Hideo Akemi?
You mean grandfather?
This explains a lot. No wonder you're so good at tactical planning. You come from a family of tacticians.
Thanks. But I don't know if that's true.
It also explains why she takes her training so seriously. As the granddaughter of the first military gear pilot, she has some large shoes to fill.
Anyway, I should get going. I'm sorry I can't play for you today.
That's okay. Are you free over the weekend? Maybe we can postpone until then.
Sure.
Great. Don't back out on me, okay? I respond jokingly, but Mayu takes me seriously.
I promise you will have your private show this weekend.
Did she just say what I think she said?
I mean, concert! I'll play then. I mean, I'll play for you then. Play my violin!
Too late. Phrasing! I try to hold back a laugh. Okay.
I have to go. Bye!
She quickly ends the call. Although I can't see her, I can imagine how adorable Mayu looks when she's flustered, and I'm a little disappointed to have missed it. Oh well, at least I have the weekend to look forward to. So we skip over to Yuna. Nobody can resist these pearly whites. I like long walks on the beach. Let's be realistic. Nope. I get it. And you can't a girl? I know, this is good night. No one finds out my secret. Let's just hit up Cowrie. Burger and fries, then... Oh, this is the eating thing. Stay quiet. Just try to slip under the radar.
You're real...
But it tastes delicious. So if you want to see her flustered, you can pick that one. What do you mean? I am on top.
I've been waiting. What about you?
Who cares if I use an outlet or my gear? I can be possessive too. We're fine with that one. Okay, I don't know why it wouldn't let me skip that. The crawl up her button died. Just let me get it, stupid rent-a-cop. Bonjour.
Your accent is adorable. What's up?
Oh, I was wondering why was the scenery so different? Like, I couldn't skip anything there, but I didn't think I did anything different. No foreplay? Crank that up to 50. Block. Huh, so it doesn't matter what you choose. She's into me. Style. Plan is good. Make it Mayu. I guess I chose that one before. Stay silent. Here's one I haven't done. There's an awkward pause.
Okay. I'll keep them distracted while you guys handle Tetsuo. You guys understand the plan?
We all nod. As of on cue, the map flashes red. GG, noob.
That's what was down.
Okay, here's the victory party. So we spent it with everyone else, I think, up to this point, with the exception of Mayu. Water. We need to be sober so we can see everyone else flip out and stuff. Making my way to the living room, I spot my... Hold on real second. Okay, so Sho is alone if you go to Sho, but if you go to Mayu, she's stalking him. So man, what is with this game in stalkers? You have Valerie stalking you, Mayu stalking Sho. We can assume Kyrie is stalking that one guy at the daycare center. It's a pretty crazy group that's probably like one step away from going psycho killer. Making my way back to the living room, I spot Mayu staying awkwardly to the side while Sho chats with his brosefs. He's shaking his head as if refusing the invitation, but his friends are persistent and won't take no for an answer. When they realize Sho won't go willingly with them, they literally pick him up and carry him away. Sho waves helplessly at Mayu, who waves back at Sho. She seems really nervous to be left on her own. As I walk over to keep her company, some guy other than from another dorm swoops in, two drinks in hand.
A pretty girl like you shouldn't be hanging out alone.
Mayu shrinks away as the guy leans in.
I wasn't alone. I was just talking to a friend.
Oh yeah? Where is he? Sorry, I didn't mean to put you on the spot. Why don't you come and enjoy the party with me?
I don't know. I should probably wait for my friend to get back.
He offers her one of the drinks in her hand.
Sure, I get it. Why don't...
In his hand?
Sure, I get it. Why don't I keep you company until he gets back? Here, I noticed you were empty-handed, so I got you a drink.
Well, there's a spot where it differs. In real life, this is a bad idea to take the drink.
That's nice of you, but I don't drink.
He laughs.
Just one drink, I promise. Then I'll leave you alone.
No, thank you. Really, I don't drink.
Come on, live a little! What harm can it do?
A lot to your liver. Mayu shuffles uncomfortably for the man's insistence. I threw a protective armor on Mayu. Hey, sorry to keep you waiting. Mayu blinks at me in surprise. The other guy narrows his eyes.
Who the hell are you?
I'm her boyfriend. Who are you? He looks at the two of us and laughs.
You gotta be kidding me! This is your boyfriend?
Mayu glances at me again, then steals her resolve and nods once, leaning into me.
Yes.
Even though I started this charade, I can feel myself growing warm from Mayu's reaction.
Forget it! This isn't worth the trouble!
With a huff, he walks away. Mayu breathes a sigh of relief.
Thanks.
No problem. We stand side by side against the wall while the party rages on around us. Mayu has her hands folded and is pointedly looking away from me. I focus on my drink. So, parties aren't really your thing, huh? She blinks at me and meets my eyes, then shyly looks away.
What makes you say that?
I don't mean that in a bad way. It's just that you don't seem too comfortable. She lets out a small laugh.
I guess not. This is more something that Sho enjoys, and I just come along to keep him company.
She gives me a sidelong glance.
What about you? Is this your scene?
They're okay. I shrug. If I'm in the mood for them, I think they're fun.
I know what you mean. Small parties aren't too bad, but a big one like this...
A loud crash interrupts Mayu as someone tumbles over a chair. A roar of laughter follows while the guy tries to get back on his feet. Yeah, this can be a little overwhelming. Mayu nods. So, if this isn't really your thing, what kind of thing do you like?
Well, I like reading.
You mean like studying?
No, like novels. Especially fantasy novels.
How come?
Because they have the most fantastic worlds! It's always so different. And when I'm reading, I feel like I'm there exploring the same magical place they are. In those worlds, anything can happen. There are no rules.
Mayu grins, and for once there's a spark in her eyes. It's kind of nice to see the side of her. I had no idea you were such a bookworm. I like to read too, but I prefer science fiction.
Really? How come?
The technology in those books are so advanced. It's fun to think that maybe one day what's written on the page will be something we use in real life too.
I've never considered that before. That would be cool.
What else do you like? She hesitates.
Promise you won't make fun of me.
Of course I won't.
I really like to play chess.
You do. She nods. Oh. She looks back down to the ground and shuffles her feet.
It's stupid, I know.
No, it's not. She glances up at me in surprise. Does Sho usually play against you?
No, he thinks it's boring. It's too slow.
Who do you play against? Mayu shrugs. Well, maybe we can play sometime. The sparkle returns to her eyes.
You think so?
Sure. I've played a few times, so don't expect me to go easy on you. She laughs.
I don't shy away from a challenge!
She's a lot more confident when she's in her element. Mayu stares at the sea of faces in the crown spots show waving at us. We should probably head over there and see what he wants. Yeah.
Thanks for keeping me company.
What are friends for? She rubs at her arm shyly, then gestures for me to follow before disappearing into the crowd. The rest of the party is a whirlwind of music and laughter. It's late by the time I get home and everyone's already asleep. I tiptoe into my room and collapse into my bed. Exhausted, I fall asleep as soon as my head hits the pillow. Mayu owes me a violin lesson. I wonder if Mayu is free today. I'm still really curious as to how she is on the violin. Taking my phone out of my pocket, I tap Mayu's name. She answers only after one ring.
Hello?
Hey, Mayu. Cash in on the private show. I was calling to see if we're still good for it to do our one-on-one session.
Of course! I made you a promise, and I have to keep it.
I think my suggested choice of words flew right over her head. On another note, I'm excited to hear her play. Alright, do you want to meet in the music room on campus?
Okay, I'll head over right now.
Great, me too. I'll be there in a few... Did she just hang up on me? Mayu Akemi flashes across my phone. Hello.
I'm so sorry for hanging up! I meant to say okay, but I just nodded my head instead.
I suppress a chuckle. She sounds so cute when she's flustered. It's okay.
Sorry again. I'll see you soon.
Alright, see you. There are a couple of awkward seconds of silence before she finally hangs up. I guess she was making sure not to cut me off this time. Sometimes I wonder if she's too polite for her own good. Time to head out. After making my plans, I head downstairs. So here we get to see what happened
okay,
to the bike.
Didn't see you there, big bro.
Okay then, I was just ignoring you.
That is so...
I arrive on campus and park as far away as I can. There's absolutely no way I want to be caught riding my bike while it looks like that. It's quite a jaunt before I arrive on the main campus quad. I'm breathing heavily and feel warm by the time I arrive, so I take a few deep breaths to cool down. Pulling up the campus map on phone, I plot out the route for the music rooms, make my way into the cluster of liberal art buildings, then enter the music hall. The first two practice rooms are empty, while the third one has a petite girl with her back facing the door. That's Mayu. She hasn't noticed me at the entrance yet. Time to bring out my inner ninja. I crouch down and tiptoe over to Mayu. My steps are inaudible due to my past training as a covert operative, the details of which I cannot narrate. Boo. Mayu squeals in surprise as she jumps away from me. Realizing it's just me, she presses a hand over her chest.
Don't do that!
She's breathing heavily. I can't help but feel a little guilty. Sorry.
It's okay.
Her voice doesn't sound very convincing. As her body tension releases, I can see something gripped in her hand. What's that? Mayu opens her hand, revealing a small canister of pepper spray. Well, that could have ended badly. My eyes feel itchy just from looking at it.
It's for emergencies. Just in case.
Does she have a rape whistle too? Yeah, I get that. I'm just really glad your first reaction was to not spray it. She tucks it away in her pocket.
It used to be, but Shao's been on the receiving end a few times.
At this point, he might be immune to it. A few times. Mayu sighs.
You'd think he'd learn. I just use it more carefully now.
Thank goodness for Shao's shenanigans. In any case, I'm just glad that Mayu seems more relaxed now. Her instrument is already unpacked and her music is on the stand. I'm surprised by how fast you set everything up.
I got here as soon as we hung up to practice.
Practice?
Yes. I haven't played for anyone outside of family, so I got a little nervous and wanted to practice.
I mean, you're just playing for me. It's nothing serious.
It is!
Mayu blinks after realizing she raised her voice. She looks down meekly and shuffles her feet.
I mean, it's... my first time.
Phrasing. Your first time?
Yes.
Her cheeks turn red and she looks away.
I mean, for first time playing for an audience.
I smirk at her reaction. I take a seat on a nearby piano bench and watch as she writes her violin and bow. She still looks a little nervous and retunes her violin to help her relax. Once content, she closes her eyes and begins playing. I'm listening to her music. I wanted to wait for her to finish, but I don't think she's going to. I'm listening to her music. She stops abruptly. Mayu opens her eyes and looks dejected.
I'm sorry! That must have sounded so awful! I made so many mistakes!
There were a few notes out of place, but it wasn't noticeable unless you were really listening for it. Maybe her nerves are affecting her performance. Okay, let's do it. You need to put your heart into it. You played it well, but you were missing a key component. Mayu looks up at me with curiosity.
I was?
Yes, your heart and soul. She blinks, unsure what I mean. Don't get me wrong. The performance was near perfect from a technical standpoint, but music is an art. You need to feel it. Let the music share what you can't put into words.
I'm sorry. I don't follow.
I turn to face the piano. Once more, from the top.
Okay.
My fingers hover over the piano keys as I glance back at Mayu. She nods at me and raises her violin. We play music together. Or not? The music fades to an end and we stare silently at each other. While there are no words, I feel the bond between us grow stronger.
You were incredible!
We were incredible. Mayu beams and nods.
I didn't know you could play the piano so well.
Just another one of my talents. I grin confidently. Beginner's luck, I suppose. Mayu's eyes widen.
That's really impressive!
I chuckle. I'm kidding. I used to play duets with my sister when we were younger.
Oh!
Speaking of hidden gifts, have you ever considered playing as part of an orchestra? To my surprise, Mayu nods.
Actually, when I was in high school, I was invited to audition for a spot in our local community symphony orchestra.
That's amazing. How did you do? She looks away.
I didn't audition.
Why not?
It's just not something I could have done.
Because you'd never played in front of people?
No, I mean, sort of. I was nervous about that, too. But mostly it was because I knew my father would never approve.
Did you ask him? Her eyes grow wide at the suggestion, and she emphatically shakes her head.
Of course not!
Why not? She sighs.
Akimis are pilots. It's in our blood, and it's what we are born to do.
But what is that what you want to do? Mayu blinks at me.
What do you mean?
Is a gear pilot what you want to be?
Yes. I've never considered anything else.
What about being a musician? The fact that you were asked to audition for a professional orchestra means you have the talent.
Music is important for a well-rounded education, and it keeps the mind sharp. But it's not a profession.
Of course it's a profession. Think of all the musical geniuses in the past. The composer who put together the music we just played.
It just couldn't happen!
Mayu blushes at her outburst.
Besides, I probably wasn't good enough to earn the seat in the orchestra anyway.
I don't believe that. She looks away and shrugs. Maybe this isn't what she needed to hear from me. Mayu shuffles her feet as silence settles in. Simple question. Do you enjoy playing music? She looks up at me but doesn't hesitate in her response.
Yes!
Did you enjoy playing music with me? She blushes.
Yes.
then the only thing left for us to do is to start a band. Mayu blinks.
I don't know about that.
It's purely to keep our minds sharp and ensure we have a well-rounded education. Nothing professional about it. A smile plays on our lips.
Well, I can't argue with that.
I propose we plan our first practice session as a newly formed band. Mayu nods.
When?
I grin. No time like the present. She giggles and raises her violin to her chin.
Ready!
This time, I lead us into a fast-paced tempo and Mayu easily keeps up. This type of music doesn't seem to be something she's used to, but judging by the big smile on her face, she's enjoyed herself immensely. We continue to play together for a while until it gets late. We schedule our next band meeting and then head out. I'm looking forward to the next session. You seem happy. Stop it.
As a matter of... I just got off...
She still digs you.
Of course she does. We're still... Who do you think you...
So, right here we have the conclusion... I don't know, modern... Okay, this found one that I clicked on. Actually... Hold on, I need to actually go back to this.
Oh, God.
Okay, that... I had to stop there because this brought up something that occurred about... I want to say, like, 2 weeks ago? I'll spare you guys the story. Aside from team stuff, Mayu and I have doubled up to create our band. She's no longer afraid to play her music in front of me, and we practice different music genres and experiment with styles. Because of our shared love of books, she's recommended a few novels to me, too. They're actually pretty good. On the home front, yada yada yada. Take your pick. Okay, here we get to put together our band. We have the additions here, if I remember correctly. I make my way to the music room. I finally convinced Mayu we should expand the band, and we're holding auditions for our newest member. After Mayu played for me for the first time, she's loosened up a lot, and we've been jamming regularly together. I found a flyer for local musicians. The community is sponsoring a talent night for both bands and solo artists. I know Mayu and I are ready to compete, and after much cajoling, I got her to agree to sign up. The only problem is a band is considered three or more people. Neither one of us wants to perform alone, so the only thing left to do is to recruit a third member. Mayu's already setting up the music room when I arrive. Hey, Mayu. She pauses and smiles when she sees me.
Hi! You made it. I mean, of course you made it, but you're early, which is nice. Not that I think you can't be early to things, but...
Her voice fades and she drops her gaze. I'm a little nervous, too. Mayu flashes me an appreciative smile.
I hope we find someone good.
Same here.
There will only be singers auditioning today, right?
Hopefully we can find someone who knows their way around a cowbell. Yeah, I think having a vocalist will best complement her sound. Mayu nods.
I agree.
I help her move some of the clutter to the corner of the room and set up a long table with chairs in the middle of the room for us to sit. This is the judge's table. Mayu sits at the table while I poke my head out in the hall. Will the first audition please enter the room? As I return to my seat, a short student with slick back hair walks in. He's changed out of his uniform and his shirt hangs loosely over his small frame. I squint to get a better look and notice his shirt is decorated with all different types of footwear, sandals, flip-flops, etc. This is going to be interesting. Mayu's brow is furrowed and she wears a hesitant smile. She seems just as apprehensive as I am. Hello, what's your name? The boy wears a goofy grin. Bill Heng. What are you going to sing today? So, his name wasn't voiced, but this is. So, yeah. So this guy is a reference to... I only saw him on Arrested Development with the judge show. He was the hung jury. Mayu and I glance at each other. This was a popular song back when we were kids. I don't remember which singing show it was he auditioned for exactly. There's just too damn many to keep track of these days. I nod. Whenever you're ready. Bill flashes us another lopsided grin as he belts out a tune. He begins to bounce his knees and stiffly jerk his hips from side to side. He sings in a monotone, and his cadence feels almost robotic. Paired with his strange dancing, he reminds me of someone gaining use of their limbs for the first time. I glance over at Mayu, who has a forced smile over her frozen on her face. Her eyes seem almost panicked. Finally, he finishes and waits expectantly for our feedback. My dog can sing better than that. The fact of the matter is, you can't sing and you can't dance. In fact, I'm sure my dog would have put on a better performance. Bill stares stoically as I give him my feedback, then looks expectantly to Mayu. She fidgets under his gaze as she tries to find something to say.
You were very brave to sing in front of us, and I think it's great that you did.
She nods, seemingly satisfied with her review. I'm about to dismiss it when someone else interrupts me.
Excuse me, but are you in the wrong room? This audition is for singers. I'm not sure what you thought you were doing up there, but it certainly was singing.
Another student sits beside Mayu. He's wearing an ace uniform without teal stripes, so he isn't a pilot. Mayu merely glances over at the student, but otherwise doesn't react to his presence. Maybe he's one of her music friends. She must have asked him to sit in our auditions and help us judge who would be a good fit. Despite the new guy's scathing comments, Bill doesn't seem fazed.
I did my very best, and that's all I could have done. I have no professional training, but I am very glad of my performance.
Mayu smiles encouragingly.
That's great! Thank you for coming by.
Yeah, thanks. We'll be in touch. Mayu's friend crosses his arms and waits for Bill to leave. Once Bill leaves, he is immediately replaced by another student. He is still in ace uniform, but contrastly, his long dark hair falls to mid-back and covers one eye.
Hi, my name is Slasher, and I'll be singing an original song I wrote myself.
So I wanted to say that this guy was going to be a reference to Slash from Guns N' Roses, but I actually don't know what he's supposed to be exactly.
Hi!
He cuts Mayu off in the middle of her greeting and screams in a hoarse voice. Oh god. I scream over Slasher before my ears literally begin to bleed. Thank you, I think we've heard enough. Mayu's eyes are wider than I've ever seen, and she flinches every time Slasher belts out a word.
Thanks. If you could please stop for a second.
Her friend clamps his hands over his ears and cringes in pain.
Stop, for the sake of our sanity.
Slasher finally quiets down, but looks confused.
Are you trying to turn us all into raving psychopaths? Because the only effect constant yelling has on me is making me angry.
What? I haven't even gotten to the killing part yet. Here, listen.
Swim in blood, it's an all!
Mayu and I shout simultaneously.
No!
No. Slasher pauses again. Mayu's friend looks like he's about to speak again, but we silence him with death glares. I think I've gone deaf. That was quite possibly the worst song I've ever heard. I would say more, but I can't hear myself over the ringing in my ears. In response, Slasher opens his mouth ready to belt out another line. Mayu immediately stops him.
Wait! Your song is definitely very original. But it's not quite the direction we're going for this band.
Whatever. You guys can't even begin to comprehend my genius.
And that's what I'm afraid of. Slasher turns on his heel and walks out of the room. I breathe a sigh of relief, but brace myself for the next audition. A girl walks in. She's wearing her ace uniform and has her dark hair pulled back into a messy ponytail. She seems normal so far, but I don't want to get my hopes up. Hello? She smiles warmly and waves.
Hi. My name is Mitsuki.
Mayu seems hopeful.
Feel free to begin whenever you're ready.
Mitsuki nods and takes a deep breath. Her voice shakes as she sings a soft melody, but grows in power as she gains confidence. Mayu and I blink at each other. She's actually good. Before long, her song is done. Oh. I close my eyes and find myself getting lost in Mitsuki's voice. Before long, her song is done. Mitsuki waits nervously for our feedback. Mayu stands to her feet, so suddenly her chair wobbles.
You were wonderful! You have a powerful voice which would perfectly complement our instruments, and the emotion behind your song. I could feel what you were singing!
Mitsuki blushes at Mayu's praise.
Thank you.
I I couldn't agree more with what Mayu said. That was a beautiful performance. Mitsuki breaks into a wide smile. The random guy raises a hand.
Excuse me, but what was that?
Mitsuki blinks, obviously confused. I'm not sure what this guy is talking about either.
This good shy girl act is so played out. Where's the confidence, the fire, and for God's sake, have you ever heard of a cold?
Mitsuki runs her hands through her hair.
I'm sorry. My last class was physical education, and I was running a little late.
I lean closer to Mayu. What's with your friend? He's kind of a jerk.
Wait, I thought he was your friend.
We stare at each other for a second, then focus our attentions on the mystery guy. Hey. He glances over at us. Who are you?
Excuse me?
He pulls a face of disgust.
How dare you? Don't you know who I am?
No. Mayu shakes her head. The guy scoffs.
Clearly, I have made a terrible mistake. You peasants wouldn't know greatness if it bit you in the ass.
With a loud sniff of disdain, he swaggerlessly exits the classroom. Awkward.
So, did I pass?
Yes. We'd love for you to join the band.
Really?
Yes, absolutely. We have your information, so we'll let you know when our next practice will be, and hopefully we'll see you there.
Thank you! Yes, I'll be there! Okay, thank you again!
So, this may seem kind of twisted, but it would be kind of neat in the band competition if we ended up having to go up against the first guy, the Slasher, and then the Simon guy as their own makeshift band or something. I don't know if the devs can actually afford that much voice acting, but that would definitely be a tense and kind of awkward moment. By the way, if Mitsuki is a reference to anything, I don't know what it is. I really wouldn't be surprised if she were, was some kind of reference, just I'm not really familiar with J-pop or something, and that's where I'd probably expect to find it. Grinning from ear to ear, Mayu practically skips out of the room.
Is it strange that I feel kind of nervous?
How come?
I don't know. I'm really excited! I'm already getting ideas for new pieces that will incorporate her voice, so I don't know why I'm so nervous.
It's probably because, after how bad those previous editions were, you're hoping this good one isn't a fluke.
Maybe.
She smiles at me.
We should probably clean up. I think our reserve time is running out.
After Mayu and I clean up the music room, we part ways so she can go to class. I can't wait to see what kind of music the three of us will create together. But in the meantime, we're skipping. I don't care. It is what it is. Valerie. Stare her down. I don't know how to answer. I won't fall for your objectification. As you wish. As accurately as possible. You're like the waifu I didn't ask for. It's like having a puppy. Where's the rest of your swimsuit? Do you value your life? Hi.
Hi.
Okay, she actually was voice acted. She smiles and gives a short wave.
Hey.
Okay.
What? Life is so unfair.
Okay, so this is when they're staring at Yuna's figure.
What?
A gentle poke to my side snaps me back to reality. Huh?
I see.
See what? She glances down and shuffles her feet.
So that's what you like.
So, any other route, she does this to show instead of you. So this alone is something different. No, you have it all wrong. I quickly shake my head. No, I don't like them. Yuna frowns. Wait, I mean I like them, but I like yours too. Mayu looks at me with wide eyes, then quickly covers herself with her hands.
Stop!
Sho shakes his head.
Broseph, have you learned nothing?
Of course not. The girls continue to watch me warily. I'm not... Never mind. So I'm going to see if I can go back and choose a different option, because we never had this before. What are you talking about? I don't follow.
You know?
I really don't. Mayu's eyes widen.
Really?
Seriously, what are you talking about? She smiles.
Nothing.
Nikki grabs my arm and pulls me over to Yuna, who still looks nervous.
You're being so rude, big bro.
Huh.
What?
Get ready, because you're next.
What? Are you serious?
Shun's face is a mixture of trepidation and hope as Valerie readies herself to leap. Right before she jumps, Valerie pauses and glances at Mayu.
Really?
Mayu blinks.
Huh? Oh, never mind. Just kidding, Sho. I already made my choice for today.
Valerie winks at me and I blush.
Aw, you got my hopes up.
Valerie laughs and is about to reply when her attention locks onto Yuna.
Oh my god!
I like them older. Sorry, but I'm into the more mature types. Valerie drops my arm.
You mean past its prime?
No, I mean more experienced. Valerie blinks, then frowns in silence.
Wow. That's a lot more harsh than I thought it was going to be.
I was wondering if Mayu would have an extra line here. Doesn't matter. Hold on, was she always there in the middle, or is that new? Yeah, I don't know. I want to spend a little more time with Mayu. I wonder where Mayu went. I explore the beach, and it doesn't take me long to find her sitting on a rock cliff, her feet dangling in the water. She glances up at me as I sit beside her.
Oh, hi.
Hello. We both watch the sun dip low in the sky, gently touching the trail of fire reflected in the water. Mayu's eyes glitter from sunlight as a peaceful smile graces her lips. She looks like the picture of tranquility. Mayu notices me staring, and I try to ignore the heat in my cheeks. As her eyes meet, she averts her gaze.
Is something the matter?
No, nothing like that.
Oh, what is it?
You look perfect in this light. I wish I had a camera right now to capture this moment.
It's a beautiful sunset, isn't it?
Yes, but it can't compare to the way you look right now. Mine's cheeks turn bright red.
What? I don't know about that.
Mayu smiles, but looks away.
But if you had a camera, then Cowdy might come and take it away.
Don't say her name. I laugh. It would be worth the risk. Mayu's blush deepens. Mayu shivers as a breeze blows by. She hugs her knees and leans closer to me. I also lean in close, we end up bumping heads. I'm so sorry. Mayu looks up at me.
No, it's okay.
Her face is inches from my own. My heart races. We both blink at each other. I can see her cheeks tinge with color, and I'm sure mine are too. She hasn't pulled away, though.
Mayu! Broseph!
We both jump apart as Sho approaches.
I was wondering where you two went.
We were just watching the sunset.
So their roles are reversed. She trails off and stares at the ground. Yeah, we wanted to catch up while we still can. Mayu nods.
Oh, cool! When we were younger, Mayu and I used to check out the sunset while our parents talked. Too bad I missed it this time.
No, you didn't, go away.
Yeah.
She glances at Sho's smiling face, and a shadow of guilt seems to pass over her own face.
Anyway, I think the gang wants to head out since it's getting late.
Right. Everyone was waiting for us when we rejoined the group. You guys didn't pack up yet?
We figured we'd do it together since we wanted to walk to the parking lot together anyway. Mayu smiles.
Thanks for waiting.
Yuna nods. We all pack up our belongings and head to the parking lot, yada yada yada. Long enough to enjoy the show. He wants to get to know me better. Huh. I received an incoming call from Mayu. Hey, Mayu.
Hi! I hope you don't think this is weird, but would you want to go to the comic book store with me?
Oh, is there one on campus?
No, it's in town. My next class is canceled, so I'm done for the day. Do you have class?
No, I'm done too. She seems relieved.
Great! I pre-ordered the new series of Boundless Stratus, and it's ready for pickup. I don't like going alone because the guys there are... A bit overbearing. They're always trying to chat, and they keep asking me to play games and stuff. But it feels weird. Show's managed a comic, and he also thinks I'm overreacting. I would just feel more comfortable having you there with me.
Sure, I'll go with you. How are you planning to get there?
By bus.
I can drive us.
Are you sure? I don't want to be any trouble.
It's no trouble. How about I meet you at your dorm where we can go together?
Okay, see you soon.
We hang up and I head to her dorm. After I pick her up, I drive us to the comic book store in town. When we arrive, Mayu hesitates before she hops off my bike. You okay?
Yeah.
She takes a deep breath and gives me a nod. I follow her into the store. As soon as we walk in, my mouth falls agape in wonder. Every staff member in the store is beyond attractive. Is that a prerequisite to working here? As I continue to look around, the patrons are all on the same level as the staff. The women have beautiful smiles and shapely curves which turn into legs that go on for days. They smile at me as we walk past. The men are all tall with broad shoulders, and I can see the faint outlines of muscles underneath their shirts. I am not in bad shape, but I still feel a little out of place. Wish I'd spent some more time on my training. What is this place? Mayu doesn't even pause and heads straight to the counter. When we walk past, the staff members greet us, but Mayu keeps her head down and refuses to make eye contact. As we approach the counter, an equally attractive and friendly man greets us.
Good to see you again, Mayu. Is there anything I can help you with?
Hi. I got an email saying my pre-order for Boundless Stratus has arrived.
I don't think we had any copies yet, but I'll double-check in the back stockroom for you. In the meantime, you and your friend should have a look around.
After flashing us a handsome smile, he heads into the back room.
Do you want to take a look at their manga?
Yeah, sounds good. Mayu leads me through the section and I browse the titles. Are you a big manga fan?
I read some.
A title catches my eye and I enthusiastically grab the book off the shelf. Oh hey, I remember this. Did you ever read this one? I hold the book out to Mayu while she examines the cover. She furrows her brow and slowly shakes her head.
No.
Really, it was super popular when we were in middle school. At least, it was in the States.
What's it about?
The main character and his family had to return home to take care of a sick grandfather who passes on a protective charm for the main character. At his first day in his new high school, he gets into a fight and accidentally activates the charm, which turns out to be a cat spirit demon girl. Once activated, the cat girl swears to protect the main character and disguises herself as another student in his class. This causes all sorts of hilarious scenarios between her and the other girls in his class.
That doesn't sound very familiar.
I shrug. It's really silly, but it was fun at the time.
Which character was your favorite?
The shy girl. I always like the quiet girl. She's really nice and understanding, and she's so cute when she gets embarrassed. Mayu grins and her cheeks turn pink.
I think I would like her too.
Anyway, I can't believe they still have it. I put the book back on the shelf. What else do you read besides Boundless Stratus?
Oh, I like Evangelion and Gundam too.
I'm beginning to see a trend here. She blinks.
What do you mean?
Well, all of the mangas you mentioned have giant robot battles. Mayu's cheeks tinge pink.
I mean, I do come from a long line of pilots. It's only natural that I gravitate towards those type of manga too.
You haven't read any other types?
No. Father wasn't very fond of manga to begin with. The only reason he let me read the ones I did was because they were sort of relevant to my studies.
Her voice lowers to a mumble.
And because he didn't know about most of them.
She stares at the ground and shuffles her feet when she catches my grin. Who knew Mayu had such a rebellious side? Let's find a manga that you'd like, that's not gear-related.
Okay.
As we both peruse the shelves, one of the gorgeous men nearby politely greet us.
Excuse me, I couldn't help but overhear you're looking for a new manga. My sister just finished this one, and she loved it.
He hands Mayu a book with a girl and a flute.
Maybe you'd like it.
Mayu shifts from one foot to the other. Thanks, man. That's really nice of you.
Thanks.
No problem.
Another man interjects.
I highly recommend that one, too. Although, there are some parts later on that deal with some heavy subjects.
Like weightlifting?
That's true.
If you want something more lighthearted, you might want to check out that author's second title.
A third man joins in on the conversation.
Oh, I've read that one. You're talking about The Boy and Alien Pet, right?
Yeah, that's the one.
That one is really funny. The two of them get into all sorts of shenanigans.
Huh. I'll have to check that out, too.
Mayu stares helplessly at the crowd surrounding her as they continue to chat. I gently pull her aside and point to the book still clutched tightly in her hand. So, what do you think? She takes a deep breath to relax, then scans the synopsis.
It's about a girl who lands her dream role as the solo flutist in a symphony. But when her mother gets sick, she has to decide between her family and her passion.
Foreshadowing?
Actually, I think this would be very interesting.
I grin. Mission accomplished. The man who originally suggested the title notices Mayu's interest in the book.
I hope you enjoy it.
Thanks!
We part from the group who are still deep in discussion. Mayu breathes a sigh of relief.
I'm glad you came with me.
Hmm?
Didn't you see what happened back there? That happens all the time!
Man, she has some really bad anxiety issues. That's what Mayu meant by overbearing? They seem like really cool guys to me. At least you got a new book out of it. She smiles at the title in her hands.
True.
After selecting a couple of titles for myself, I glance at Mayu. Let's go check on your pre-order. She nods happily. We head to the counter where the clerk is waiting for us.
Here is your pre-order.
Thanks!
I place the books I picked up on the counter and hand over my card. I'd like to check these out, please.
Oh, yeah.
I think she forgot about the manga in her hand. She puts it on the counter. I include that one in my purchases, too. She blinks at me in surprise.
You don't have to do that!
I know. I want to. I smile at her and she blushes.
But you've already done enough just by agreeing to come here with me.
That's not much. Any good friend would do that. She's still hesitant.
I appreciate it, but...
Here you go, sir.
The cashier returns my card and hands me a receipt and a bag full of all my books, including Mayu's. What? Mayu's eyes are wide as she stares at the bag. The cashier winks at me.
Have a nice day.
Thanks. I grin at Mayu. Consider this an early birthday present. Mayu blushes deeply.
Thanks.
As we head towards the door, Mayu bumps into someone.
I'm sorry!
She looks up in surprise.
Mei?
Hi, guys!
I didn't know you liked to read manga.
Oh, yeah. It's a secret pleasure of mine.
Really?
Mei grins appreciatively as one of the men walks past. So that's what she meant by secret pleasure. At least I'm not the only one who sees this. Mayu furrows her brow.
View? It's inside a mall plaza.
Mei raises an eyebrow. I understand her look all too well. How is Mayu not seeing this?
Anyway, I've got some things to check out, so I'll see you later.
She heads deeper into the shop while Mayu and I walk outside. Ready to head back? She nods. We hop on my bike and I drive us back to campus.
Thanks for taking me to the comic book store.
Thanks for introducing it to me. Now I know where to go to catch up on my series. She smiles.
I'm really happy you like to read manga, too. Sho doesn't really care for it.
That's surprising. You think he'd like it more since there are pictures. Mayu giggles.
Be nice. Anyway, Father will be here soon, and I still have to clean.
By clean, do you mean hide your new books? She blushes.
It would be best if you didn't know.
At least it's not Harlequin stuff, that's all I can say.
Anyway, I'll see you later.
Now that I think about it, I don't actually know if there's like a Harlequin equivalent to manga. I really wouldn't be surprised if it's somewhere in the shoujo category. But who knows, maybe it's not as trashy as it is here in the US. I wave goodbye and watch her disappear into her dorm. I'm a natural. So I have to choose someone to spend some time with? Kaori, maybe? Counterattack. No, you're sucking too much. Kaori wears makeup? You just told me. Skip. And double skip. Who needs luck when you're this good? Let's go for a Super Smash Melee Brawl. Jeez, sucker wouldn't go down. So yeah, I don't really care. We're taking her on. This is getting out of control, people. Let's give her space. I was about to say, I'm not going after her. Let's talk about it later. Yeah, he's clearly into me. Something safe. This explains a lot. Still going to lose. So we have to spend time with Yuna in the baking club. Doesn't taste how it looks. At least you have a mom. She's missing out.
How dare you say something like that to a lady?
Climbing around on her sweatiness.
How about I show you? I promise, only when you deserve it. Step one is to teach you how to block.
Don't try anything.
There's nothing happening. I'm not thinking anything.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Get out. I'm not going to fail my test because you're being a total weirdo.
No, you're going to fail your test because you're a dunce. Yeah, I'm leaving. I glare at Ken again. Just remember, whatever you're thinking of doing to her, I will do to you.
It's just math.
Twice.
Out!
Nikki shoves me out of the room. Door?
I know. We'll leave the door open so you stop being stupid.
She can call back. Is Mayu free to hang out? Keep in mind, if you go to Kaori, that locks you out of all the other routes. It's kind of messed up how they had that set up. Now, I know they are working on a new visual novel. I'm hoping they don't have, like, a kill switch. Or, like, a kill flag, I guess. This late into the game, like they do here. I call up Mayu, but she doesn't answer. I guess she must be busy. Suddenly, my phone flashes with a callback from Mayu. Hey, Mayu.
Were you just calling me?
Yeah.
Oh, I was just calling you too.
Huh, no wonder you didn't answer.
Yeah.
She falls silent. Is something wrong?
I don't know what to do.
What do you mean?
I don't know. I'm so confused.
Then go with the red pill. Leave that blue pill alone.
I saw her again with Sho, and he was laughing at something she said.
Who?
I don't know! I've seen them together a few times now, and she...
She takes a deep breath.
I'm sorry.
Even though she hasn't outright said it, it's obvious that Mayu is worried that Sho's become interested in someone else. Mayu, I get it.
You do?
Yeah. She pauses.
Do you think it's nothing?
I don't know.
Has Sho told you anything?
No. She falls silent. When she speaks again, her voice trembles.
Maybe it's time I give up.
Okay. So let's face it, as much as we like Mayu, she and Sho are like the Ace Academy dream team, right? I try to push my feelings for Mayu aside. Her heart is with my best Brosef, and I don't want to get between two people I care about. You shouldn't give up.
Really?
You should tell Sho how you really feel. She hesitates.
I don't know. What if he doesn't like me back?
He does.
How do you know?
He'd be a fool not to. She's silent again, and I wonder if I made her blush. Maybe I shouldn't have said that. What I mean is, you two have known each other since forever. There's no way he doesn't feel the same way about you. She's gone silent. Mayu, are you still there?
Yeah.
What's wrong?
Well, now I'm worried about what would happen if he says yes.
He'll probably want to go on a date.
A date?
Well, yeah. That's what you do when you're a couple. Based on that nervous sound, I bet she's blushing. I can't help but smile. Are you nervous?
I've never been on a date before. What am I supposed to do?
Just be yourself. It's not much different than if you're hanging out as friends.
But what if I say something stupid?
You'll be fine.
I don't think I can do this. I'm too nervous.
You can do this, Mayu.
I can't. I'm so embarrassed.
Her voice trembles again. Do you want to practice with me?
What?
You can pretend I'm Sho and we're on a date. That way you'll know what to do and you won't have to be nervous.
I don't know.
Think of it like a simulation match to practice for the real battle. She chuckles softly.
You would do that for me?
Of course. She hesitates.
If it's not too much trouble, I think that would be very helpful.
So yeah, if you've seen any romance thing ever, you can kind of guess how this is gonna play out. Sure, it's no problem. Should we meet at the cafe?
Well, there's usually a lot of people there.
I don't want to suggest her dorm. I doubt she'd be okay with that. There's no one home, but I wonder if she'll get the wrong impression if I suggest my own house. I guess there's only one way to find out. You can come over to my house if you'd like.
Your house?
We can stay in the kitchen and pretend we're at a restaurant. Nobody's home at the moment, so you don't have to worry about people staring. She's quiet. If you're not comfortable, that's okay too.
Okay.
Okay. She takes a deep breath.
Yeah, we can go to your house.
I give her the address. I'll see you in a few minutes then.
Yeah. See you soon.
We hang up and I try to clean up the house a little before Mayu arrives. I pace restlessly around the house, checking for nothing and everything. Why am I so jittery? We are just two friends hanging out together, as friends, in my house, alone. The sound of the doorbell startles me, and my heart beats frantically. It's just Mayu, your friend. I open the door, and Mayu smiles nervously at me. Hey, come on in.
Thanks.
She slowly steps inside and glances about the living room.
You have a beautiful home.
Thanks. It's not really mine. She looks at me curiously. I mean, it's my uncle's.
Oh, right.
We stand awkwardly in the doorway. Okay. So, I guess, what kind of date do you want to pretend to go on? She seems unsure. Would you like to go to dinner with me? The restaurant is really close, right around the corner, actually. I point to the kitchen. Mayu grins.
That sounds lovely.
I lead her towards the kitchen. I hope they have space for a last-minute reservation. Mayu giggles as she slides into a seat at the table. Would you like a water or anything to drink? She shakes her head.
I thought you were supposed to be my date, not my waiter.
I blink at her joke. Mayu seems a lot more relaxed than when she walked in, which helps me relax too. I grin and slide into the seat opposite her. You're right. How rude of me. There's another pause. Mayu fidgets in her seat. I glance at her and she shies away from my gaze. She twists her hands in her lap and looks around the kitchen. Suddenly she sighs.
I'm hopeless.
Why do you say that?
We've only just started and I already have nothing to say.
Just relax. Don't think about it so hard. Mayu takes a deep breath.
I still don't know what to say.
It's okay. Let the conversation flow naturally. You and Sho hang out all the time, right? She nods. Being on a date isn't much different than hanging out as friends.
Okay.
What do you and Sho usually talk about?
I don't know.
She wrinkles her brow.
I can't think of anything. But now that I think about it, it's usually Sho who does all the talking.
Okay, I'm trying to keep my composure here. Because usually in relationships, it's the other way around. The girl does all the talking while the guy tries to find out a way to escape. Don't worry, let's just start talking and see where the conversation takes us. How about we start with... Have you had a chance to start your new manga?
Actually, I did.
She smiles. How do you like it?
It started off a little slow because they were introducing a lot of characters. But now that they're finally focusing on the main character, it's gotten very interesting. She joined the symphony orchestra after graduating high school, and quickly moved up to first chair. I've just gotten to the point where her mother is sick.
Oh no.
Yeah. She moved out of her hometown because of her job, but since her mother is sick, she feels obligated to move back home.
What about her job?
She'll have to quit.
That's a tough decision.
Yeah.
What would you choose? She blinks at me in surprise.
Well... I choose family, of course. What about you?
I'd make it work. I shrug. I'd find a way to balance work and my family obligations.
It's not always that easy.
No, but it's not impossible either.
I suppose not.
Mayu looks at me a little strangely. What is it?
Sorry, I didn't mean to stare. It's just... Sho never asks about what I'm reading. He's not very interested in books.
Okay, I'm trying to keep it together. Mayu seems to be in better spirits now that I've gotten her talking. That wasn't so bad, right? She smiles.
No, it was nice, actually.
I'm glad. Let's see, what else do people do on dates?
Go to movies?
Yes, good idea. I'll take care of the check and then we can head over to the movie theater. Mayu giggles.
Thank you.
I hold out my arm for her to take, which she does after a moment's hesitation. Her cheeks turn pink and she looks away, but there's a smile on her lips. We walk the few steps back into the living room and I lead her to the couch. We've got a lot of different movies and shows. Is there something in particular you feel like watching? I try to remember which genres Mayu likes. I'm trying to remember how many wisecracks I did during the Resident Evil games on the channel. You do not want to be around me around a horror movie. I just can't take those seriously. I remember during the party at Sho's place that Mayu told me she likes to read fantasy books. Maybe her tastes in movies are similar. I think Nikki downloaded the latest Harriet pilot movie, too. She perks up.
Is that the one about Harry's granddaughter?
I think so. Have you read the book? Mayu nods.
Yeah. I was a little skeptical because this is the author's daughter who's revived the series, but I was pleasantly surprised. It keeps you on your toes as much as the original series did.
I agree to a certain extent. I feel as if the daughter's trying to overcompensate on world-building sometimes includes features or items that feel a little forced, but her character relationships are very solid. Mayu cocks her head to the side as she ponders what I said.
Yeah, I can see where you're coming from.
Should we watch this then?
Yes, please.
She blushes at her outburst.
I mean, if you want to, that's fine with me.
After selecting the movie, I stream it to my TV and Mayu and I settle into the couch to watch. We end up chatting through most of the movie anyway. Mayu is all smiles and she laughs at my jokes, even the stupid ones. As predicted, once she was comfortable and relaxed, the conversation flowed easily. We got into an in-depth discussion about whether or not magic and gears could really be used together like in the Harriet Pilot books. At one point, Mayu moved her arm and accidentally knocked over the remote. We both reached for it at the same time and her hands touched. I'd never seen her face so red before. We continue to chat long after the movie's over, and before we realize it, the sun is beginning to set.
It's getting pretty late.
I glance at the time in surprise. I can't believe it's already been a few hours. It only feels like we've been together for a couple of minutes.
I had a nice time, although I'm not sure if I actually learned much about what to expect on a date.
Mayu looks at me and blushes. I pretend to look disappointed in myself. I failed as a teacher.
Don't say that! I just was not a good student.
I'm more inclined to believe Mr. Miyagi on this one. No such thing as a bad student, only a bad teacher. To my surprise, her gaze locks onto mine and she doesn't look away. My heart pounds in my chest as the blood rushes to my face. Mayu's face is just as red. A loud vibration interrupts us. Mayu pulls out her phone.
Oh no! I forgot! I promised my father I was going to send him a report of our match this week! I told him I'd get it to him today, but I haven't started it yet!
I nod. Alright, don't let me keep you. She looks apologetic as she stands up to gather her things.
Thanks again!
I smile. No problem. Mayu heads out before it gets too late. This was the most fun I've had in a long time. Still, I wonder what would have happened if the phone call hadn't interrupted us. I try to shrug away at the thought. The date might not have gone the way I'd planned, but I'd still consider it a success. Mayu managed to feel comfortable in a more intimate setting, and hopefully she picked up a few tricks, too. You finally adulted. It's all business, no pleasure. So I don't know what all is going to be different here. Phrasing!
That's not what I meant!
So we're gonna send Mayu, even though she won't end up doing it, it's gonna be Valerie in the end. Mayu can do it! Mayu's eyes widen in horror.
No!
She turns her back to us.
I won't do it. It's too embarrassing.
Valerie giggles.
Aw, she's adorable when she's all shy.
Leave her alone.
I don't get what the big deal is. We've already seen you in a bikini before.
Mayu's blush brightens.
It's not the same.
She wraps her arms tightly around herself on the verge of tears. Yuna and Kaori hover over her protectively.
It's okay. You don't have to do it.
Well, that didn't work out. Who would actually be willing to do it, though? I think I know. How about Valerie? Wait, where did she go? Everyone notices the lack of blonde hair spunkiness beside us. I look around and spot her already on the stage, pulling her clothes off.
Valerie!
Valerie cocks her head to the side, sporting an alluring bikini.
Why? Why were you wearing that underneath your clothes?
It's a photo shoot. Aren't you all wearing yours?
Kaori clenches her fist.
Of course not! What sort of dumb logic is that?
Valerie grins impishly.
Oh, even better.
Huh?
You're wearing something nice and private underneath, aren't you, Kaori?
What?
Is it black? Maybe lacy?
Kaori's face turns red.
Stop being a pervert!
Valerie laughs, show nudges me.
That's the first time she called someone other than us a pervert.
It was only a matter of time. She grabs the Dashu energy drink, with one hand forms a peace sign with the other, winks suggestively at the camera.
That is perfect! You're a natural!
We watch Valerie expertly transition between poses as the photographer snaps image after image. She's completely in her element. The girls are a little too focused on her. I can't tell if it's from admiration, jealousy, or a little bit of both. Valerie shakes the drink, then pops open the bottle. The carbonated liquid explodes all over her face. She catches the liquid in her mouth and wraps her lips around the bottle. I can't look away.
That's enough!
Yuna pulls Valerie off the stage and pushes her towards the changing room.
Hey!
You ruined my shoot!
You've got plenty to use already.
Yuna is uncharacteristically firm, and the photographer is taken aback by her directness.
Yeah, okay.
Great.
She shoves Valerie into the changing room. My heart feels like it's about to beat out of my chest. Sho's face is frozen in awe. Kaori is uncharacteristically quiet, and her face is as red as a tomato. Mayu is pensive, as if she's trying to analyze what she just witnessed. Yuna's cheeks are just as red as Kaori's.
That was...
We nod. There are no words to describe what we just saw.
That was a lot of fun.
So we'll move forward with the show. Yoink! Okay, here we go. I look over his medallion before safely pocketing it, then head back to my friends. Before I make it back to the group, I'm intercepted by Mayu.
Wait!
Huh? Mayu? How come you aren't with the others?
I wanted to give you something.
What is it? She bites her lip and fidgets as if struggling through some inner dialogue. Mayu, please, we're in public! Oh. Suddenly, she thrusts an envelope into my hands.
Don't read this until you get home.
What?
Promise you won't.
I promise. She nods. Her cheeks are tinged pink and she refuses to meet my eyes. Just as abruptly as she arrives, she rushes back to the group. I flip over the nondescript envelope, wondering what it could say. Still, I promised her I wouldn't read it, so with great reluctance, I put the letter in my pocket and rejoin the group. After eating our fill from the buffet, we continue to mingle and meet other Dashu sponsees. Everyone we spoke to was excited to hear about Dashu is supporting the ice team, wished us luck. Okay, here we go. Mayu sways to the music, a smile on her face. Every so often I catch her glancing at me, but she hurriedly looks away. A blush spreads across her cheeks whenever I catch her staring. As she gets into the music, she relaxes and I catch her singing along. I park my bike in the garage and fish in my pocket for my keys when my hand touches the envelope I'd forgotten all about during the concert, but the same trepidation from before rushes back. Should I wait to read it? Nikki is probably waiting for me on the other side of that door. I remember Mayu's face as she shoved the letter into my hands. This must be important if she would subject herself to that kind of embarrassment. I tear open the letter and read through. I tried so many times to write this, but the words never came out right. I don't know how to tell you that in these past few months I feel closer to you than anyone else. You've helped me grow as a person. Playing my music and forming our band was a dream I never thought would come true, but you made it happen. Talking to you about chess was the only time I wasn't embarrassed to admit I play it, and I was thrilled to find out we read the same books. You always seem to say exactly what I need to hear. Yesterday was the first time in a long time that I felt like I could be myself around someone. You were helping me get over my fears again, and I feel like when I'm with you, I can be strong. I had so much fun yesterday that I was sad to say goodbye. Nobody makes me feel the way I feel when I'm around you. I love the time we spend together, and I want to have even more of these moments with you. I clutch the letter in my hands as I digest Mayu's words. So yeah, there are a lot of ways to actually get off her route. So many false choices. My hands shake as I reread the letter. I feel the same way when I'm around her too. I want to have more days like yesterday with her. pulling out my phone, I prepared to text her. Is this really how I feel? My thumbs type out a short response. I feel the same way. There's a pounding in my ears as I wait anxiously for her reply. The seconds feel like an eternity before my phone vibrates. You don't know how happy I am. I was so worried you wouldn't feel the same way. Sorry, that emocon just sunk the deal, Mayu. Maybe we should just be friends. And I did hit the mic there, sorry. I catch myself grinning stupidly at nothing. Can this day get any better? I've been sitting in this garage for a while now. I should probably head inside. Nope, didn't get an autograph. Bet I could change that. Try me. It's not my place to tell. Things have been going amazingly well between Mayu and I. After the incident with her letter, the next time we saw each other was a little awkward. We knew our relationship had changed, but we weren't sure how, and it made us both self-conscious and unsure how to act around each other. The more time we spent together, the more we relaxed. We realized our relationship is still the same, just better. Every time I'm with her, I feel lucky to have her. And then, yeah, no one cares about Nikki. Halloween blows. Seen my masterpiece. Yeah, take her upstairs so she can get some clothes. I'd rather be sleeping, man.
Gross there! Naughty nurses, echo girls, maids!
I pull the phone away from my ringing ear. Alright, I got it, jeez.
Hurry up!
I'm on my way.
Good. I'll see you there.
After hanging up, I throw my phone down on the bed, trying to make myself look presentable. So she dresses up as some sort of magical girl type thing. Kinda tempted to go to the police officer just to get a reaction out of her. I don't know, Ninja Ranger maybe? Balance, Ranger of Justice. Still trying to remember what. We'll go back and play this out.
Hey!
So I'm trying to remember which one it was Kaori liked. Damn. Because I know I said Tome was my favorite, but I don't know. I probably should just go back and check out the other options there, but it doesn't matter. Sho and I weave through the crowd and make our way to the girls.
Hey!
Sho's demeanor changes mid-word from excited to confused.
Hey there, cuties.
Hello!
Hi. Mayu smiles and waves. Sho's face is bright red and he's having trouble making eye contact. I don't blame him. Kaori's wearing a night outfit from a currently popular fantasy anime. In a typical anime fashion, the armor is more aesthetically pleasing than functional. As a healthy heterosexual male, Yuna's witch costume makes it hard to focus on her face. Mayu's dressed in a cute magical girl cosplay. I'm impressed by the intricacies of her costume and how well it complements her. Finally, Valerie. I think the plethora of guys ogling her speaks volumes about her Neko girl outfit. Valerie spins her tail playfully.
So, what do you boys think?
What a time to be alive!
Valerie giggles.
Let's go get some drinks.
We all nod and head over to the bar. As I'm about to follow the group, someone slips their hand into mine. I glance over at a blushing Mayu who quickly retracts her hand.
Sorry.
I smile. What's up?
I just wanted to...
She looks me up and down curiously.
I like your outfit. A hero suits you well.
Thanks. I'm kind of tempted to go for the police officer real quick, but we've already recorded this, let's just go forward. Mayu looks back down again and shyly steps from one foot to the other.
So, what do you think of my costume?
All that's missing is a tentacle monster! Don't magical girls usually fight monsters in manga and anime?
That's right.
If only there was a friendly neighborhood octopus around. Mayu furrows her eyebrows.
I'm not sure what you mean.
Well, you know, an octopus has tentacles.
Yes?
Magical girls and tentacles?
I don't follow.
She tilts her head to one side and looks at me with curiosity. There's no way she doesn't know what I'm hinting at. No one who likes manga and anime can be that innocent. You really don't know what I mean. She shakes her head.
Sorry.
I pat her on the head. Don't worry about it. It's an inside joke. She blushes at my touch and nods.
Okay.
Let's go meet up with the rest of the group.
Sure.
Now we'll go back and hit the other route. Be nice if you could tell her to take out her phone and do a quick Google search, but oh well. Super adorable, of course. Mayu blushes.
You really mean that?
Of course. It looks like it took some time to put together.
Yes. It was a little hard to put on, but hearing you say you like it made the trouble worth it.
Anytime. She plays with her skirt but looks pleased nonetheless. Let's go meet up with the rest of the group.
Sure.
Mayu beams and waits for me to lead the way. Once we've all reconvened at the bar, we order our drinks and find an open table among the couches.
It's so unfair that I still can't have anything alcoholic.
Valerie pouts and puts an arm around Mayu.
Isn't that right?
Mayu speaks softly.
I don't want to drink even if I could.
Really? You have to at least try it once.
I feel Sho elbow my side.
If she's this excitable normally, I wonder how she'd act when drunk.
I don't even want to imagine the trouble she'd get us all into. Sho laughs.
Screw that, bros.
Hey, enough with your private conversation. Let's play a game.
Yuna perks up.
Oh, that sounds like fun.
Mayu nods excitedly. Even Kaori seems interested.
Okay, what game were you thinking, Valerie?
Well, in honor of Sho's cosplay of Yosuke.
Not Yosuke!
Mayu looks surprised.
Really? I thought you were Yosuke this whole time.
Sho slumps on the table.
Not you too, Mayu.
I'm sorry. It's just you portray him perfectly. With that outfit, I mean.
Wasn't Yosuke the comic relief?
And a pervert.
It's like someone copy and pasted that character and changed the name to Sho. The group nods. Sho groans.
You guys are killing me here.
Yuna looks at Valerie.
What game were you thinking about? The King's Game.
The King's Game?
Mm-hmm. It's easy. We number chopsticks and give one of them a special symbol. Whoever picks the symbol is the king.
Oh, that sounds easy enough.
What can the king do?
The better question is what the king can't do. He'll command one of the numbers to do something, and his order is absolute. Don't worry, it's a lot of fun.
Well, I guess it couldn't hurt to try it.
Everyone looks at Kaori in surprise. She's the last person we would expect to agree to a game like this. She blinks at us.
What? It's only us playing. I'm sure no one is going to make an unreasonable command.
Kaori glares at Sho.
Right?
Sho shifts uncomfortably.
Right!
Then it's settled!
Valerie grabs some chopsticks and marks them with numbers, and then marks one of them with a color. She shuffles them on the table and then holds them in her hand so the marks are covered.
Let the games begin.
My heart races in anticipation as we all grab a stick. I turn my over and see the colored marking, Lucky. I watch as the rest of my friends turn theirs over. Kaori wears her best poker face. If I already have the King's stick, I wouldn't know what she had in her hand. Sho's face is one of bitter disappointment. I wonder what he had planned as king. Mayu breathes a sigh of relief. I guess she didn't want to be the king. Valerie seems indifferent about her stick. She probably would be just as happy as king or subject. Yuna looks around the table.
Who's the king?
I offer my glorious crown, chopstick.
Rosef's got it. What is your command, your majesty?
Let's think for a moment. I command... Okay, Mayu's number 3, if I remember correctly. So I kind of wonder if you'd actually get a different reaction out of the girl by getting something from someone else. Like, would they get mad? Would they have some sort of jealous line? Or what exactly? The thing is, I don't actually know how much effort the devs put into this last part to really branch out the routes. This is one of those parts that can get very complicated very fast. Okay, I had to take a break there. So, Mayu is number 3. We can tell it's just from process of elimination. First time I played this, I did show. This was Valerie, Yuna, Kaori, so Mayu's only one left. Number 3. I need a massage. As one, everyone stares at Mayu. She blushes under a collective gaze.
The king's orders are absolute!
Mayu shuffles her feet uncomfortably, then nods.
I guess I don't have a choice. Okay.
Her face scrunches with determination as she joins me on the couch. I turn around so my back is facing her. I can feel the presence of her hands hovering above my back.
So, do I just...
Soft hands touch my shoulders and gently begin rubbing them. I sigh contentedly as the tension slowly leaves my body with every movement of her hands. This is some professional-grade relaxation I'm feeling.
Like this?
I barely register her words through the bliss I'm feeling and nod slowly.
Wow, Mayu. How are you doing that? He's like pudding in your hands.
Oh, I used to work as a masseuse.
What? Really?
Not a licensed masseuse. I used to work part-time as an assistant.
You're incredible. Please teach me how to do it.
I can try, but I'm not really that good.
I could definitely get used to this. Mayu's cheeks redden. Her voice trails off.
Oh my gosh, she is just the cutest thing ever.
Mayu stops her massaging. Over already?
Yep.
I should have specified the minutes in my command. I was really enjoying that. The group notices my pout and starts laughing. So, I guess there isn't really a big event, it was just that little trail at the end that was unique to Mayu's round. We played a few more rounds of the King's game, and Sho never once drew the colored stick. Watching his frustration as some of us became repeated Kings was an endless source of amusement. I wonder if his luck is really that bad, or if a certain blonde was rigging the game for her own amusement. When it became late, we all said our goodbyes and headed out. I stifle a yawn as I enter the house, tiptoeing into my room. I quickly get ready for bed and fall asleep with a smile on my face. Best Halloween ever. It's Valerie. Who calls this early? Everything. Here's the curse. We got 99 problems and a curse ain't one of them. So here they're playing that whole getaway event, which we're gonna end up spending with Mayu, and then we also have her.
Just that you're really smart.
What's that supposed to mean?
Okay. Mayu smiles.
So
apparently her route is about building her some confidence.
I guess. If everyone...
study, I guess. You'll be fine.
I guess. See you guys later.
How is this unique? He sighs deeply one last time before heading off. What are the odds he'll actually study?
Slim to none.
Alright, well, I'm out. I'll see you guys later. Oh, we have a Mayu event here. I wonder if Mayu's up to anything. As I'm debating whether or not to call her, a call comes in from her instead. Hey, Mayu.
Hi.
What's up?
I wanted to see if you'd like to go to the bookstore with me again.
But this time we're not going to the hentai section. Sure. I finished reading the manga I got last time.
Me too. Actually, that's why I want to go back. I really liked it, and I want to get the second volume.
That's great. Are you ready to go now?
Yeah. If that's okay.
Sure, I'll meet you there. After hanging up, I go and get ready. I hop on my bike and drive to the bookstore. Since I'm the first to arrive, I decide to wait for Mayu inside. The same employee from before is at the counter and greets me warmly.
Hey, good to see you again. Welcome back.
Thanks.
Is Mayu not coming today?
She is. We're coming separately. That sounds like Akira's voice actor.
Oh.
I'm really surprised he remembers me considering I've only been here one other time. An employee smiles at me. She has flawless skin and legs that go on for days. Then again, the store is atypical in basically every other way, so maybe I shouldn't be surprised. The doors chime Mayu's arrival. She waves at me.
I hope you weren't waiting long.
Nope, not at all. Let's go find your book. She nods and we head off into the shelves. I browse for anything interesting while Mayu goes straight for the series she wants. After making my selection, Mayu is still browsing the shelves. Did you find what you're looking for?
Yeah, but then I also saw this manga, which I think is interesting. Or maybe this one?
She trails off, lost in thought, holding an adventure series and a romance series.
Which do you think I should get?
Why not both?
I don't want to get too many at once. I like to get more as I finish reading.
Well, get whichever interests you more. She stares hard in concentration.
I'll just be another couple of minutes.
Oh god, we're gonna be here all day. Okay, I'll meet you up front then.
Okay.
When I return to the checkout counter, the clerk rings me up.
Did Mayu like the manga she got?
Yep, she liked it so much she let me borrow it so I could read it too. He seems intrigued.
Did you like it?
That sounds creepy. It wasn't bad.
What did you think of the fanfic?
I blink. What fanfic? He seems surprised.
You don't know the fanfic?
Where can I find it? The first clerk takes a tablet out from behind the desk and pulls up the webpage.
Here you go.
I skim through the chapter note on the top of the page. The main character gives up her musical career and returns to her hometown to take care of her mother. She struggles to adapt to her new life, but is reunited with her childhood friend. So far, this is staying true to the manga. Her childhood friend introduces her to a new guy in town who is also a musician. After a few months of hanging out, she realizes she is developing feelings for him. He grins at me and the heat flows in my face. I quickly look away. What is going on? I've seen that same smile a million times before. It doesn't mean anything. Except that it means everything. Knowing that his attention is on me, no one else, makes my heart beat faster. There is an electricity swirling in currents around us, making the air thick. Do you think we should invite the others, he asks, and my heart sinks. Why am I disappointed? After all, we're only friends. I shake my head to clear my thoughts, and he frowns in worry. We don't have to invite them if you don't want. I don't want to. I want to smile and tell them it'd be nice to spend some time with just the two of us. No, we should. I think they'd all enjoy it too. Why did I say that? He flashes me another warm smile and my knees go weak. Oh, of course. That's why.
Hey, guys!
I glance up at as Mayu puts her books down.
What are you reading?
Just a fanfic.
I didn't know you liked fanfiction. Is it good?
I'm indifferent. It's alright, I guess? I don't usually read this stuff, so wouldn't know what's considered good.
Really?
Here, let me read you a section. So all that stuff I just read... Mayu's face drains of color, then turns bright red. I pause. Have you read this before? The store clerk begins laughing as Mayu's blush deepens. I look from one to the other. This is strange. What's going on?
Well, actually...
She looks away, seemingly too embarrassed to finish.
She wrote it.
What?
Yeah, Mayu shared it with me, which is why I was surprised you hadn't read it yet.
Really? That's pretty cool, Mayu. She blushes again.
You think so?
I figure she wrote it, that's why I chose indifferent. Yeah, it seems like a lot of people like your work too, so you should be proud. She smiles.
Thanks.
We continue to chat about Mayu's writing. The clerk gives her a discount on her purchases, which Mayu is thrilled about. After promising to return soon, I offer Mayu a ride back to campus.
Thank you for coming with me today.
No problem. I'll be looking out for your next chapter. She blushes.
Please don't tell the others, though. I'm not sure they'd understand.
Your secret is safe with me. She smiles in appreciation, and an idea pops into my head. In fact, maybe I can help you with some new source material for your writing. She blinks and furrows her brow in confusion.
What do you mean?
Here's an example. I scoop her into my arms, and feeling bold, I plant a long kiss on her lips. At first, she's surprised, but it doesn't take long before she melts into the kiss. I gently pull away, and her cheeks are flushed. She glances away, but smiles.
Thanks. That will help a lot.
I grin. Let me know if you need any more help researching. She blushes deeply, but nods.
I better get back.
See you soon. She smiles and waves goodbye. Who knew Mayu was so creative? Not only does she play an instrument, but she also writes. Wonder if she can draw too. That would not be a good thing. If you don't know how manga artists, we'll just say mangaka since they're writer artists, live, it's not good. They only have like a couple hours of free time per week since they have to put out an issue every week, with the exception of holidays, which is like 1 week in Japan, I think. Yeah, I do not envy those people. Well, enough of the thought, I head out.
Do you have any experience buying a gift for a lady friend?
You're talking about Hitomi, right?
Yeah, I still can't believe she's into me.
Me neither. She laughs.
Thanks for the vote of confidence.
Anytime.
So, does that mean you'll help?
I can't leave my bro hanging. Well, if you're worried about her waistline, this is bad. Stuffed animals, you just need to make sure you hide something inside of it. Jewelry is probably outside of his price range. Do you even have to ask? Get her chocolate.
I don't know.
Have you ever met a girl who wouldn't eat chocolate? Show things hard about it.
No. No, I haven't.
Sad part is, I don't think we've met Hitomi yet, so I don't know her interest, because when he's dating Mayu, you can tell him to get a book. Exactly. Show nods.
Good thinking, Broseph. Let's go. It's our 1 month.
You're celebrating every month? Jeez, that'll get expensive fast.
Huh?
Well, if you have to celebrate each month of being together by buying each other a gift, that adds up really quickly.
We're not celebrating each month. That'd be crazy. Just the milestones, like 3 months and 6 months.
Right. Milestones. Anyway, congrats on your 1 month.
Thanks. I'm actually kind of surprised by how it happened.
How did it happen?
I kind of saw it coming, actually.
I try to hold back my laugh, but a snort escapes. She looks curiously at me. Sorry. It's just hard to believe he wasn't oblivious for once.
Well, it was the weekend after our victorious defeat of Onabugeisha. Hitomi stopped me as I was heading home to congratulate me. She brought me a cake and it said, yes or no.
Yes or no what?
That's what I asked her. Or wanted to. Before I could speak, she said, we should go on a date.
So, she asked you. His cheeks turned pink.
Yeah.
And you said yes.
Yeah. I mean, she's never been shy about her feelings. I could tell she was interested in me, but I thought maybe it was because...
He trails off. Because what?
Because she was hypnotized by my supreme gymnast body.
My face almost show laughs. And here I was worried that it was something serious.
I couldn't resist. But seriously, I'm so lucky that she's into me. I don't want to screw this up.
You will.
That's why I want to make sure this present is special.
I know. On that note, we better get back to searching.
Right.
I helped Sho pick out the perfect gift for his lady friend. He ended up going with my advice and buying her a box of gourmet chocolates. As we exit the store, Sho has a spring in his step, but he seems both nervous and hopeful. I hope she ends up liking her present. We say our goodbyes in the parking lot. Kaori, I think this is the daycare center. Be happy for the time you spent together. Soon I'm dreaming about Mayu steaming up the hot water. So right now we have to go off the beaten path. As I glance around the group, everyone seems to be focused on the greenery around us, especially Mayu. She kneels beside a large yellow chrysanthemum and inspects its layered petals. The guide finishes his spiel about some other flower or something and leads the group further down the path. Mayu isn't paying attention and continues to look at the flowers. Mayu! She begins to stir and I wait for her to rejoin us, but to my surprise she steps off the path to examine another flower. She must not have heard me. She might go lost if I don't go after her. I slip away from the group and jog up to Mayu. She's ventured into a patch of bright yellow chrysanthemums. I'm a couple of steps behind her when I call out again. By the way, if you don't know the significance of the chrysanthemum, this is supposed to be the emblem of the Japanese royal family. In case you're curious, at one point in history, I don't know when they actually adopted this, but there was actually a lot of royalty who had a flower as their symbol. The most famous one, of course, is the French rose, but there are other ones. The Japanese had the chrysanthemum, and the U.S. never had one because we don't have royalty. So we just have an eagle, something that flies around and craps over everything that everyone else cares about. Mayu! She jumps in surprise and whirls around to face me. Unfortunately, she trips over her own feet and is precariously close to falling on her face. It was so fun to watch. Like, in real life, that's probably what I would do, but yeah. Instinctively, I step in and catch her in my arms. Maya looks up at me with wide eyes, then quickly looks away as her cheeks burn red.
Thank you.
I help steady her on her feet. No problem. Are you okay? She nods and looks back up at me, her eyes glittering.
You saved me!
I'm not sure I would go that far.
No, you did!
She seems pretty adamant. Okay.
And in the books, the hero always gets a reward.
Well, that is my name. Mayu quickly gets up on her toes and pecks me on the lips. I blink in surprise. Her face is bright red, but she wears a small smile. I can't help but grin and pull her into a hug. I'll have to save you more often. We spent some time together before rejoining the group. Wow, that was pretty short. I think that's the shortest one. But I'm so comfortable. So here, Valerie goes over her manual. Kinda surprised my mouse is showing the loading thing so often right there. Like, I'm not actually doing anything intensive on the computer other than record, so I don't know why I'd be struggling a bit. Nope, didn't see a thing. Or hear a thing. Oh, right, we still have Coach Ivan to do. Huh. So, here's the tournament. You'll do great. Wonder if you chose athletic, if you could, actually keep up with her in the tennis match.
Stop being mean, Valerie!
Okay, here we go.
What if he's scary?
Keep in mind they're talking about Coach Ivan here.
I've heard he yells at first-year pilots, who are worse.
Mayu's eyes widen.
What?
Valerie pats Mayu sympathetically on the back.
It was nice knowing you.
No, but why?
Her eyes well up with tears.
Stop being mean, Valerie.
I place an arm around Mayu. I won't let anything happen to you. She looks up at me and blushes.
Okay.
Valerie's just teasing anyway. Valerie smirks. So we have a small additional scene there. That's kind of neat. So as you can decipher what he says. So yeah, Ivan, hopefully you can get a shirt before we meet again.
Okay. So, what do we do until then?
It is reading week.
No. Mayu, don't say it. No!
Kaori covers her ears.
Idiot! What's wrong with you?
Anything but that.
So...
Mayu sighs, then glances my way as if seeking approval.
He won't focus if someone doesn't keep him on track.
You won't take care of me? What about me?
Don't worry, he can do it later tonight.
Phrasing. The dusty pink stains my cheeks, judging Makari's blush and Yuna and Valerie's impish smile. I'm not the only one who heard it like that. Mayu blinks at us, then her cheeks flush when she realizes what that sounded like.
Study session! That's all I meant.
Right, that's fine. I can't help but feel a little disappointed, even though I know that's what she meant. Show size.
Guess I don't have a choice in the matter.
Well, his choice is to go willingly or kicking and screaming. I recommend kicking and screaming. Tonight is the talent show. Mayu, Mitsuki, and I have been practicing non-stop since auditions, and we're feeling as confident as ever. Maybe. Uncle kinda let me borrow his car so we can load the instruments and any other equipment. I hope the girls are ready for me. I give Mayu a call. She answers almost immediately.
Hi!
Hey, Mayu. Are you ready to go?
Yep. I have Mitsuki here, too.
Hey!
I hear Mitsuki through the line. Okay, I'll be there in a few minutes.
Okay. See you soon.
Once we hang up, I drive to Ace and pick up the rest of my team. Then we head straight to the venue. The talent show is being held at a local music club. It's already full of patient spectators and participants waiting to set up. Mitsuki sees a friend and dips out to say hello while Mayu and I wait for our turn to play. Most of the bands are actually pretty good. I guess Isokaze is full of untapped potential. Mayu and I bob along to a particularly catchy pop song. Although a smile is on her face, she hugs her arms tightly. I put my arm around her and she glances at me in surprise, then leans into me. Are you nervous?
Yeah.
Don't worry. We're going to be great out there.
I know, but...
She looks around and hugs herself even closer.
There are just so many people.
Once we're on stage and the spotlight is on us, you won't even be able to see them. It'll just be like when we're practicing. She nods slowly, mulling over my words.
That makes sense. Thanks.
She grins. Mitsuki returns as we're on deck to play next. She bounces excitedly backstage.
We're really going to do this, aren't we? I'm so nervous. My heart is beating so fast. Are you nervous?
Where's the bathroom? Eh, we're okay. We're gonna be fine. Are you kidding? We worked really hard for this. I'm ready to give it my all. Mitsuki grins.
Yeah, you're right. We're going to be amazing out there.
Even Mayu seems to relax a bit.
Let's do our best.
Soon we're introduced onto the stage. Mitsuki bounces out, a ball of energy, while Mayu and I slowly follow suit. I take a deep breath and try to clear my mind of everything. The cheers from the audience slowly fade away as I play my first note. Mayu's violin joins in the melody before Mitsuki's voice rings loud and clear. I let the music envelop me, twisting my senses with the ebb and flow of the melody. My fingers dance across the keys on their own as I listen to the chords I know so well. When I strike the last chord, the note hangs in the still air before the crowd erupts into applause. My breath comes out in short gasps after giving my all in that performance. Sweat drips down Mitsuki's face as she takes a bow, and even Mayu's cheeks are flustered. As she rushes off stage, Mitsuki pumps the air excitedly.
That was amazing! Good job, guys!
Yeah, I think that was our best one yet. Mayu looks as if she's in a daze.
Listen to the crowd!
The cheers and applause are still going, but slowly dying down as the next band preps to go on stage.
Oh, there are my friends. I'll catch up with you in a bit.
Mitsuki runs off again to chat with some of her friends who came to the show. Mayu and I head back to the audience.
I'm going to go freshen up. I'll be right back.
Sure, I'm going to get a water. I'll be by the bar. Mayu nods, then heads off to the ladies' room. I order water and down it at the bar. As I wait for Mayu to return, a girl approaches me and smiles shyly.
Excuse me, are you part of that band that just played?
Yes, I was the one playing the cowbell. I blink in surprise. Yeah, I am. Her face lights up in excitement.
Oh, you guys are so wonderful out there!
Thanks.
How long have you been playing the piano?
Since I was a kid, I started a little later than most, but that just motivated me to practice harder.
That's still really impressive. I appreciate a guy who understands hard work.
She brushes my arm playfully. Wait, did I send the wrong signals? Actually, suddenly she pales. Are you okay? Her eyes widen at something behind me. She looks like she's seen a ghost.
I...
I look behind me and see a glimpse of the most innocent smile. When I blink, I see Mayu looking confused. Oh, when did she get back?
I've gotta go!
Before I can even say goodbye, she disappears. That was weird.
Who was that?
I think she was a fan of our band.
Really?
Yeah, I'm not sure why she left, though. Mayu touches my arm and smiles.
Too bad she couldn't stay.
So, this is definitely thumbnail-worthy material. Mayu looks at me with curiosity. Wait, what was that? I think I've been in Japan so long that I'm starting to imagine things. We stick around for the rest of the set and enjoy the music and ambience. Mayu sighs. What's wrong?
Nothing. I've just been thinking about next week.
I'm not looking forward to exams either. Studying has really been stressing me out. I need to do something to let out all my pent-up energy.
Me too. What do you normally like to do to let off steam?
It's been a while, but back at Sia and Y, my friends and I would go paintballing whenever we needed to let loose. Mayu blinks.
Paintballing?
Yeah, have you been? It's really fun. She shakes her head. Really? Well, I'm definitely taking you then. Her eyes widen.
Okay.
Trust me, you'll love it. How about we go this weekend? She nods.
Sure. I could use a break from studying.
Great. After all the performances are over, the winners are announced. We placed in third. Okay, I was actually thinking that was going to be the place, and I don't know how many of you actually are familiar with that movie, but yeah. Mayu and Misuki practically skip back to the car, and I can't keep the grin off my face. This was a great end to a great evening. After dropping the girls off at Ace, I drive back home. Optimistic. So, is this the final one? I think so. You worry about your stuff, I'll worry about mine. Not a valid concern. Everyone stares at Mayu. She blinks and pokes two fingers together.
If we try...
The team laughs. I'm happy to see Mayu finally start to come out of her shell. I'm so lucky to have her. So that was just that one line. This will be a glorious duel. I'll strike. Boost. Parry. Unparryable. Stay to the plan. Stick to the plan. She knows what to do. I stay quiet and watch in silence. Neither Sho nor Mayu make a sound either. A focused Kaori is an unstoppable Kaori. Readjust and raise her weapon. Yada yada yada.
But isn't anyone else concerned by a...
We are the champions, my friends. I don't watch this. Suckles. So this is when Mayu's in the room, if I remember correctly. I wake up unexpectedly and blink my eyes at the sunlight filtering through my curtains. Is it morning already? I wonder what woke me up. For some reason, I can't get the feeling of being watched out of my head. It must be my imagination. I whirl over in bed to check the time when I see a dark-haired woman sitting beside my bed. Mayu? She smiles cheerfully at me.
Good morning!
what are you doing here?
Waiting for you to wake up.
She must have noticed the expression on my face because her eyes widened and her cheeks turned pink.
No, not like that. To study.
What?
I came over so we could study together, but you were sleeping so soundly, and I didn't want to disturb you, so I thought I'd just sit here and wait for you, and...
Seemed totally stalker-like. She finally pauses to take a breath.
I'm sorry.
Mayu practically leaps out of the chair and reaches for her bag.
This was a bad idea. I should go.
Wait. I jump out of bed and grab her arm to stop her and pull her towards me. To my surprise, she doesn't try to resist like I'd expected, and she ends up losing her balance and falling on top of me. When she meets my gaze, her face turns red and she quickly looks away. My cheeks must be just as flushed. We immediately pull apart from each other. Get ready and then we can study.
Okay.
I grab my clothes and head to the washroom and get dressed. After I return, Mayu is sitting at my desk with her books and notebook open. I gather up my tablet, textbooks, and join her. After a couple of hours, Mayu has to head out. I walk her to the bus stop, then when I return home, I hop back into bed. I need a nap after all that studying. Before long, I'm fast asleep. So yeah, her study session has the least everything. Length, choices, what have you. Sounds good to me. Maybe Mayu would like this. Yeah, the wooden doll. Look at that, so he used pressure to get something for Hitomi. Magic of not being single. Okay, maybe this event doesn't appear for your... I don't know. As she stretches, I notice a few guys staring very obviously at her, but Kaori is too focused to notice. They got lucky this time. Hey, Kaori. Oh. Why would you want to gain mass as a girl?
I'm not trying to bulk up the way you think. But even if I were, it'd be none of your business.
It's her choice. Ready to begin. How much of her weight is just muscle? A smile creeps on her face.
What's with that look?
Was that Eito?
How did you know?
I have a younger sister, remember? I know what that grin means.
It's not like that.
What did he ask you? She refuses to answer. I guess I'll have to make my own conclusions then.
What? Don't be stupid. He just asked if we can go get some snacks for the daycare. We're meeting at the mall.
Looks like I'll have to play Cupid. You know he's interested in you, right? It's a mall date. Her cheeks brighten in color.
What are you saying?
Come on, I saw the way you two look at each other. It's totally obvious. I expect Kaori to snap at me, but she looks surprisingly meek. What do you think of him?
Well, he's responsible, hardworking, and disciplined. And also really sweet with the kids.
Might be gay. That's a better answer than I anticipated, but she didn't answer my question. No, I mean, do you like him? She remains silent, but her face somehow turns even redder. Under my unfaltering gaze, she reluctantly nods. You need to let him know, then. She looks unsure for a second, then shakes her head and glares at me.
I'm not having this conversation with you!
Looks like I'll need to take matters into my own hands. While Kaori starts to put the weights away, I grab her phone. She still has her text thread with Eito open. Kaori freaks out and lunges for the phone. She grabs for my hands, but not before I manage to send a text. Dinner after?
Why would you text him that?
Kaori punches me on the arm.
Now he'll think I'm so... Ugh! The daycare is going to be so weird when I see him again!
She's about to hit me again when her phone vibrates. She freezes and grabs her phone. What did he say?
I would love to, Kaori.
Kaori's cheeks are still red and another smile plays on her lips as she continues to stare at the message. Where is my thank you?
Shut up!
Kaori scowls anytime I mention Eito's name. We head our separate ways, yada yada yada.
Thank you.
My alarm wakes me up and I get out of bed feeling exhilarated. It's been a long time since I've gone paintballing, and I can use the distraction. I get ready for the day, need a hearty breakfast. I can't skip on the most important meal of the day if I want to win. I hope Mayu is ready for me to get her. I better give her a call. She picks up almost immediately.
Hello?
Hey, Mayu, are you ready?
As ready as I'll ever be.
Her voice betrays her confidence. You okay?
Yeah, I just hope I'll be okay at it.
You'll be great. Some with as much tactical knowledge as you'll be a natural.
I hope so.
So, are you ready for me to come pick you up?
Yes. Yeah.
She sounds much more certain this time. Okay, be there soon. So I imagine this is when we're going to have our showdown with her father, or, yeah, I think it's her father. Because as important a role as he's supposed to play in her life, we've yet to meet him or anything. After we hang up, I hop on my bike and head to Ace. Mayu waits for me outside her dorm and greets me with a smile. Once she's situated on my bike, we drive off. I went online last night and was surprised to find that there was a paintballing range in Isokaze. It's a few hours away, but didn't look too bad of a drive. I pre-programmed the GPS coordinates into my helmet, so once we hit the road, it was a smooth ride to the range. We arrive at a wooded expanse. There are trees stretching as far as the eye can see and a cabin close to the parking lot. That must be where the registration desk is. A good number of people exit the cabin and head towards the trees. That's encouraging. It means a better game for us. Mayu seems intimidated by all the people, so I throw a reassuring arm around her shoulders and squeeze gently. She glances up at me and smiles. Let's go inside and get her gear.
Okay.
That sounded like that was coming through the phone filter. We speak with the clerk and receive our suits, glasses, vests, paintball guns, and ammo. We've been placed on the blue team, we'll be fighting against the red team. Mayu looks wide-eyed at all the gear in her arms.
This seems way more intense than I thought.
It can be intense, but not as much as these items make it seem. After getting changed, we meet up with the rest of our team. With the exception of one other girl, Mayu is the only girl on the team. The rest are guys who look to be in their 20s. After introductions, we huddle to discuss plans.
So the objective for this game is to capture the other team's flag, which means they're also going to go for our flag.
So that's Akira's voice actor, and I wonder if the guy actually talks like that, because it sounds like he does that for all of his characters.
Have any of you played before?
There's a mixture of responses. It seems like most people on our team are newbies too.
That's fine. It's not hard to pick up. We'll need some people defending and others on offense.
Mayu leans into me.
Which side do you think we should be on?
With your sharpshooting experience, I think we'd be a huge benefit for the defensive team.
I can do that.
If we see the offensive team needs help, we can hop in then too. The team starts gaining everyone's preferences and splits people up. Once everyone's been split up, we take a look at the field. For the most part, we're all out in the open space with sparse tree cover, which means our flags have no cover either. That makes it harder for us to defend, but also easier for us to spot enemy advancement. If we see someone on the enemy team, we'll shoot them with our paintballs. If any paint gets on them, it means they're out. Mayu grins.
That sounds pretty easy.
But that also means that if we get hit, we're out too.
Okay.
Also, don't shoot your own teammate, or they're out too. Her eyes widen and she nods.
Got it!
That's basically how you play. She giggles.
Paintballing 101.
As we get into place, the game begins. Mayu and I stake out an area a little farther away from the flag, which keeps the flag in plain view. If anyone tries to get close, they'll be an open target. We bank on the fact that we aren't directly in the line of sight and won't be spotted right away. Other teammates crowd closer to the flag, hoping to be the one who shoots first instead of getting shot. As expected, the other team begins trickling into view. They dart from cover to cover, hoping to stay hidden for as long as possible. It's easy to tell the more inexperienced people from the experienced, so they get taken out almost immediately. Plus, with suits like this, you don't really blend in. I mean, that's orange and black in a green environment. There's a reason hunters wear orange. Mayu stays her gun and focuses her aim. Every time she shoots, she hits her target square in the chest. Even before the rest of us have warmed up, she's already taken out every single attacker she sees. If she keeps this up, there won't be any players for the rest of us to attack. I stare at her in awe. She's even more awesome out here on the field than in her gear matches. Once people figure out where her shots are coming from, we quickly abandon our post and begin running. Mayu continually shoots a stream of paintballs, taking up multiple targets. She is even more lethal in motion. One of the attackers escapes her view, though, and heads straight for the flag. Pow pow. I steady my weapon and pull the trigger. The attacker's red vest is stained with a larger blue splat.
Nice one!
Thanks. Mayu has the place on lockdown. The people coming to steal our flag are fewer and fewer as Mayu meticulously takes them out. I glance to the other side of the field and see most of our team members have paint splattered on them. Mayu, it looks like our offense could use some help. What do you say? She nods. We take off running toward the enemy base. We dart from cover to cover, hoping to stay hidden for as long as possible. While undercover, Mayu aims her weapon and shoots at any defenders in sight.
Let's take out as many as we can before we have to dive in.
Right. She expertly aims at her targets and hits them square in the chest. Like a machine, she fires shot after shot. Once the defenders realize where the shots are coming from, they quickly abandon our hiding spot and sprint towards the flag. As a moving target, we're harder to hit, we use that to our advantage. My aim suffers a bit, and there are a few times where I miss my mark, but Mayu doesn't seem affected. For every one of my misses, she has me covered. I'm going to make a grab for the flag. Cover me.
Got it!
Trusting Mayu to have my back, I lower my weapon and make a break for it. There's no time limit here. Swipe. Would have been better if there was actually a yoink option. Weaving among the defenders, I zero in on the bright red flag. Without slowing my pace, I reach my hand out my hand and grab it, then we make a wide turn and run towards the group. My breath comes out in ragged gasp, and my legs burn, but I refuse to slow down. Suddenly, Mayu yells.
Look out!
There's a paintball heading my way. Derp was an option. I skid out of the way, and Mayu takes out the attacker. Then I continue racing back to base, Mayu on my heels. My chest feels like it's about to burst, but I refuse to lessen my pace. I can see her base in the distance, and through sheer force of will, I increase my speed. Mayu continues to cover me. I focus on closing the distance between me and the base, one step at a time. When my foot steps over the line, we make it safely back, signaling the end of the game. Everyone gathers around in high spirits and congratulates each other. Once the initial high of wearing winds down, the focus turns to Mayu. She glances nervously around her.
What exactly was that out there?
Her eyes grow wide.
I'm sorry, I've never played before.
Everyone wears a mixture of shock and awe.
Did I do okay?
Okay. You were incredible.
Mayu blinks.
Oh.
She blushes as the compliment sinks in.
Thank you.
I pull her into a hug and grin. You single-handedly demolished basically every enemy on that field. She blushes deeply.
I'm not sure about that.
If it weren't for you, we never would have made it back, and you didn't let a single person get close to our flag. Mayu beams as the compliments keep flowing in. I knew she was dangerous during our gear matches, but I had no idea just how lethal a sharpshooter she really was. She really is one of a kind. Everyone gets ready to begin the next match. Ready for round two? Mayu smiles and nods. We play a few more rounds and try out a variety of modes. No matter what game type we choose, Mayu continues to demolish everyone on the field. At one point, the enemy team was allowed more players in the hopes that would balance out the teams, but all it did was provide more targets for Mayu to hit. The sun is beginning to set by the time we're done. After we get changed and return our gear, we go into the cafe next door. So, how was it today? Her face lights up.
That was so much fun! I can't believe I've never done it before!
Me neither. You rocked it.
Next time, I'd like to try the one game where everyone is pit against each other.
Deathmatch? I grin. I don't know how I'd feel having to play against you. I think I like having you on my team better. She blushes. We finish eating and get back on my bike to make the drive back home. I turn the engine, but instead of starting, my bike makes a weird noise. Mayu tenses against me.
What's that sound?
That's the sound, mean. We're walking. I don't know. The noise grows louder as I try again, then I hop off. After an inspection, I still don't know what the damage is. I need to take my bike to a garage. I'm not sure what the problem is and don't want to put us in danger by driving home.
I understand.
I check my GPS for the nearest garage when one of our paintballing teammates waves.
Great game today, guys. You heading home now?
We would, but I'm having trouble with my bike. Do you know if there's a place nearby I can go to get it fixed?
There's one not too far away, actually. I can take you over, if you like.
Mayu smiles.
I hope that won't be too much trouble.
Not at all. We can hook it up to my truck.
I help him hook up my bike, then Mayu and I ride with him in his truck as he drops us off at the nearest garage. When we arrive, the mechanic does a quick check and hands over an evaluation sheet. It seems like it might be a transmission issue, which I think would be in line with the weird sounds. Can you fix it now?
We have a few cars ahead of you that we need to take care of first.
It's just that we're in kind of a rush.
Sorry, earliest I can get back to you is tomorrow morning.
I sigh. I can either try to drive home, which would be a terrible idea, or spend the night here and go back tomorrow morning. Alright then. I return to Mayu and relay what the mechanic said. We're still over an hour away from home. I suppose technically we could taxi home, but I don't want to leave my bike here unattended. Mayu shakes her head.
It doesn't make sense to taxi all the way home and then come back again in the morning. That'd be expensive too.
Yep. I nod. I'm going to find a motel. You don't have to stay with me though. Maybe we can call someone to pick you up. Mayu looks worried.
I don't know. It's really late, and I don't want to disturb anyone at this hour.
Mayu keeps shooting glances at me. I think I understand what she's hinting at. Do you want to stay with me? She blushes and nods. Alright. I find a decent-looking motel within walking distance from the garage. There is weather damage on the bricks outside, but otherwise it seems to be in good condition. When you walk in, the lobby is small and conservatively decorated, but the front desk agent is helpful, and the people who walk by the lobby seem to be normal. I walk up to the front desk. I wonder if she'd chew you out if you chose the other one. Do you have room available for the night? The agent clicks through her system and nods. I glance over at Mayu. On second thought, I don't want to make her uncomfortable. Actually, do you have two rooms available for the night? The front desk agent clicks through her system and nods. Let me get that taken care of for you. We wait patiently as she finds us rooms and hands us our keys. So I'm kind of curious, does that... What happens if you choose this one? No, doesn't matter. So yeah, we'll stick with the one room thing, then. Mayu and I head upstairs to our rooms. Luckily, they're right next to each other. She glances at me and hovers in front of her door, but doesn't go in.
Are you going to go to bed?
If Mayu's asking me this, does that mean she wants to hang out more? Not necessarily. Are you? She shakes her head. Want to come in and chat?
Yes!
I open the door for her, and she smiles her thanks as she walks into the room, then settles onto the bed. I sit beside her. Sorry today didn't go quite as planned. She places a hand over my own.
It's okay. I had a lot of fun.
She looks away and blushes.
I always have fun when I'm with you.
I squeeze her hand. Me too. We continue to chat about everything and nothing, and the hours tick by. Soon, I'm stifling yawns. We should probably get some rest since we'll be heading out early in the morning.
Okay.
She looks worried and doesn't move. Are you alright?
Yeah.
But she looks far from alright. She sits on my bed with her eyes lowered. Seriously, are you okay? What's wrong?
It's really embarrassing.
Hey, come on, it's me. You don't have to be embarrassed. She shifts uncomfortably, then speaks.
I'm scared of being alone.
I blink. But don't you live alone?
It's not the same. I'm in a dorm with a lot of familiar people, so I don't feel alone. This place is a little scary.
Do you want to stay here with me? Her cheeks turn pink and she looks away. Then she nods. All right. We can share the bed. I lay down on my side of the bed. Mayu's eyes widen.
Oh, we're sharing the bed?
Well, there's only one. I can sleep on the floor if it makes you more comfortable. She blushes.
It's okay. We can share the bed.
Are you sure?
It's okay for boyfriends and girlfriends to do that, right?
Right. I gently crawl beneath the covers as Mayu curls up on her side. So, this one or the other one for the thumbnail? So far, I'm still leaning towards the other one. She faces me with a smile, then shivers slightly. Respect her personal space. I scoot closer to her. Mayu tenses up as she senses my approach, so I stop. Instead, I gently rub her arm. Before I can pull away, Mayu takes my hand into hers and smiles. She's such a different person from when we first met, but also the same. She has the same qualities that I love, but she's learned to come out of her shell a little more, and is beginning to embrace who she is. She's smart, with a quiet strength that surrounds her like an invisible force, drawing me closer to her. The more time I spend with her, the more reluctant I am to leave. I'm completely head over heels for her. Mayu closes her eyes and uses my arm as her pillow. I can't help but grin. I close my eyes and enjoy the peacefulness of her company. Mayu's breathing slows and steadies. I think she's fallen asleep, and I drift off to sleep with her. A gentle shake jolts me awake. I blink open my eyes and am greeted by Mayu's kind smile.
Time to wake up! We have to go get your bike!
My bike?
Yep. It's at the garage, remember?
As the thick fog of sleep slowly lifts, I remember. My bike. Right. Hopefully it's fixed by now. I crawl out of bed and freshen up a bit in the bathroom. Once Mayu and I are ready, we walk over to the garage where my bike is waiting for pickup. I give it a quick once-over. Seems okay. After turning my engine, the bike roars to life. Satisfied, Mayu and I hop on and we make the drive back to Ace Academy. I drop her off at her dorm and Mayu carefully slides off my bike.
Thanks again for taking me out.
Thanks for putting up with me.
It was a lot of fun. Maybe we can do it again.
Of course. She smiles.
I'll see you later.
She waves goodbye and I watch her disappear into her dorm. Once she's out of sight, I drive home. So right here is the end of the game. Be there in a minute. We have one more scene with Mayu, then it's credit time. Then we'll hit up the gallery to see what all is still there, and probably not make an effort to get the rest. I insist. I'm not convinced. That Ken guy looks awfully shady to me. Sorry to bother you, Mayu, but do you think we could meet?
Is everything okay?
I must sound weird because the worry immediately creeps into her voice. Honestly, I don't know. I just found out something huge about my parents and my core.
Oh. Okay. Where would you like to meet?
I can come to you. She pauses. Mayu?
I'm in my room.
Oh. I'm not sure how to ask if I can go there without sounding like I have ulterior motives. Luckily, I don't have to.
If you want to come here, that would be okay.
Are you sure?
Yes.
She doesn't even hesitate.
I mean, yes.
Thanks, Mayu. I'll be there soon. We hang up the phone. As if in a daze, I make my way towards her dorm. Mayu greets me at her building's entrance. Her smile falters when she sees me, and she furrows her brows. Wow. Compared to the other dorms we've seen so far, hers is pretty decent. I don't remember how Sho's looks, but I think it's a little different from this one. We don't speak as she leads me to her room. I sit on the couch and look around the room as Mayu joins me. This dorm definitely isn't like the others. Not only is the couch plush and comfortable, she also has a fireplace and a kitchenette. Feels more like a studio than a dorm room. Mayu blushes.
Sorry for the mess.
Everything is neatly arranged on all surfaces, and her floors are spotless. You have a really nice room.
Thanks. It's smaller than my room back home, but I still prefer this one. I like how cozy it is. Even though the dorm belongs to Ace, this room somehow still feels more like mine than my room at home ever did.
I spot the manga novels lying in her shelves and her little fantasy figurine she must have painted. I'm sure her father would have not allowed her that in her room back home. Now, I don't actually see the figurines anywhere here. I'm glad she's found a place where she can express herself. She glances curiously at my hand.
What are you holding?
I look down and barely register my clenched hand. That's right. Opening my hand, I show her the drive. She cocks her head to the side. It's the data to my core.
What are you doing with it?
Just storing it for now. She pauses.
Okay. But what about when you're done storing it?
That's what I'm trying to figure out. She fixes her big doe eyes on me. I recount everything I've learned so far. Mayu lets me talk and my story comes out in a non-chronological mess. Every so often she would nod to let me know she was still listening, but otherwise she did not interrupt. Once I'm done, she looks down.
That's awful. I don't know what I would have done if I were you.
Maybe I acted too quickly. She looks up again.
No!
I blink at her outburst.
You did what was right, which was really brave of you.
Then how come it still feels like I was wrong? She places a sympathetic hand on my arm.
Because that decision is a hard burden to bear. And I'm sorry you had to be the one to make it.
Somehow her words make me feel a little bit lighter. I hadn't realized how anxious I was about what I had done until someone validated my decision. I look away. I'm sorry. I guess I'm not that fun to be around right now. She shakes her head.
It's okay. You're going through a lot. I can't imagine what I'd do if I were in your shoes. I know it's hard to have one image of your father, and suddenly that image is cracked to reveal a new person underneath.
I just keep wondering what if he told me. Maybe he'd still be alive.
You mustn't think like that. I know I'm probably the last person to tell you that, because I'm always thinking about all the ways my life could have turned out differently. Focusing on your father's death and wondering if he'd be alive is dangerous. If you aren't careful, you'll be stuck in the same moment forever, and it'll consume you until you forget about your own life.
She looks at her feet.
It must be hard to have your dad taken away from you so suddenly, but that's a fact that can never be changed.
I know, but still. My voice trails off. What am I even trying to say? Mayu smiles gently and leans close to me.
He loved you very much.
How can he be so sure?
That video he left you. He knew you would find it.
She seems so sure of her answer. Her soft smile warms me up from the inside and soothes my aching heart. Her quiet gentleness is a strength in itself, and with her support, I can feel the pain and fear ease. She's right. I know Dad loved me and Nikki, and this event shouldn't change my mind about that. He was only doing what he thought was best to protect me, and no matter how much I wish he would, he could never come back. I pull Mayu into a hug. Thank you. I don't know what I would do without you. She blushes deeply and looks up at me. As if drawn to her, I lean in and let my lips gently brush against hers. She blinks in surprise, then quickly melts into the kiss. As we pull away, I gaze deeply into her eyes. In this moment, I have clarity. It rinses away all my stress and fears. It's okay that I don't have all the answers now, because I'm looking at my future. That's the fourth and final route of the girls. There might be something for show, but doing these routes eats up a lot of time. I have to record them and edit them, then upload them. If you notice this one, it was recording like 45 minute segments each, I want to say, so every 45 minutes was one sit down, approximately. And unfortunately for the editing process, once I have them actually properly spliced together, aligned and everything, as needed, it takes 30 seconds for every minute, so if this is going to take, like, if the whole video is 3 hours, that means it's going to take 90 minutes to finish editing. Just kind of curious who Akira's voice actor was. Oh, right here. Miguel Moran. So it's going to take 90 minutes for the software to actually process the file. Then from there, it has to be uploaded. And it's... YouTube's kind of confusing. It used to take something like... basically 1 minute for every 30 seconds of footage, but it's been changing lately, and I can't really tell if there's any sort of consistency to it. But the key thing to know is that for uploading a 3-hour video, it's going to take around 4.5 hours. So hopefully you can see why I really don't want to do shows route, why I wasn't really crazy about doing all the girls' routes. When I was actually doing this an hour at a time, that wasn't as bad, especially since I didn't always have to edit the individual pieces. It just made things a lot smoother overall. But anyway, with this one out of the way, I'm probably going to start turning all of my time and energy over to World End Economica. And then there are a couple of small projects I'm going to do here and there, finishing up Natural. Then I have a couple other small ones to do. But I know there was some talk about actually doing a sequel. After some consideration, while I wasn't really satisfied with the ending here, like, a sequel isn't going to necessarily fix some things. Which is why, anything, I think I'd be in the group of just make a new game, learn your lessons, and move forward. First ride, I remember when those, actually, yeah, okay, I don't know when those would pop up. We have all of these, and I guess Mayu was there the entire time, wasn't she? Yeah. Yeah, I remember where the whole intersection thing was for her. Maybe that's when we're following her if she catches us midway or something. Don't remember the couch scenes. Like, I don't even remember an opportunity to sit on her couch. You probably have to do a different route to get there. So here's her confession. Kinda surprised these are... there were so many there. My favorite Mayu picture so far. And we actually have all Mayu stuff. With a trick on the eyes. Day 2. So I'm only missing some Kaori stuff. Well, there you have it. So there aren't any exclusive CGs for a show. He kind of got the short end of the stick, but that's his problem. So with this, Ace Academy is finished. Overall, I like the fact that it was partially voice acted. I say partially because, well, there were some segments where the lines weren't properly recorded, there were some where they weren't properly filtered. And then, I didn't really mind all the silhouettes. It would make a little bit of sense for Mitsuki to have one, I'd say, but that kind of did clue you in that she'd be a decent singer. The main reason why I'm saying this is think about Kaori's route, how many people actually have sprites, Edo, her uncle, and... as far as I can tell, like, her route is the only other one that does. For Yuna and Valerie's, they didn't actually have anyone. Mayu did, but Mitsuki was blacked out. And now, granted, Kaori did have the whole convention scene, but that was just a whole fourth wall segment, so it doesn't really matter. But yeah, that concludes Ace Academy. So, if the devs put out another project, I'd look into it. I can't guarantee that I'd actually go ahead with it. If you haven't noticed from my visual novel uploads, I really don't care for the dating sim type ones. I try to go for ones that are more actually about an adventure rather than just trying to hook up with someone. So, as long as the dev's next project is more in line for the whole adventure thing, I'd be willing to look at what they're doing, in contrast to Love in Space, where their next game looks to be just pure fluff with no real adventure. But those are my thoughts. I'm done for now. I'm the Hero of Light. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.